James into Ingle. 1-0 Chelsea.
And here goes Russo!
Brighton. Kerr! 1-0.
It's Rachel Williams with the goal!
Chelsea, FA Cup winners, 2022.
The Women's FA Cup Final is here. The top two in the WSL going head-to-head in front of a sold-out Wembley Stadium under sunny blue skies. It's what Sundays in May were made for.
You think it's all over?
Take it to the gun.
Summer 2022, when there's roaring and bawling in all the stands. The Lioness has conquered the Euros with her. For 110 minutes, that pitch was a wild jungle. And people not even into footy was a fan.
Damn.
Lioness's boy at home for the club, because you can't beat a lioness when it's protecting its cub. Oof, historical moment. Don't you love it when the impossible's chosen? Or should I say historical moment? Peak TV record? Broken. Women's football centre stage where it belongs. It's just a shame that it's taken this long. Half cheering for red, half cheering for blue. Already know who's top of the table. It ain't safe when man is coming for you. Alessia Russo, banging 4 goals in the Euros. Elite star striker and she laces up boot holes. Scored against Brighton in the semis. Opponent's legs were jelly. Roofed it through the net, was so impressive. One against Durham, sheer fighting endurance. Hyping and cheering, lightning perseverance. Priceless the demand there. It's nothing when you're worth
half a mil on a transfer.
Then there's Ella Toon, she's the top goal scorer at the age of 2-3. Scoring non-stop like she was born with 10 feet. What she got in store when she falls in Wembley? Then there's Mary Earps, phenomenal work. Who keeps it clean but ain't afraid to get in the dirt. Respect is deserved, one of the best in the world. These women picked a football kit as well as a skirt. Half cheering for red, half cheering for blue. This next team needs no intro. It's mad when Chelsea is on the move. Crazy winning streak from the renowned establishment. The team with barely any space now in the cabinet. 11 major honours under legend Emma Hayes. What else do you expect with phenomenal management? And players like Sam Kerr with so many fan girls. The Aussie with leg strong and still so advanced. Girl making a big name, making a big change. Yeah, she's a big player, loves to play big games. Erin Cuthbert, seasoned footwork. Don't matter if she's placed in middle, forward. Guru writing, top tier football titan. Another great football icon. You know what time it is when you see the colour blue come into the pitch. Now, here we are. Look around at the crowd. A place where self-belief exceeds self-doubt. Women at large, these women are tough. The 53rd edition Women's FA Cup. As the tale unfolds of red versus blue, historical Wembley clash, old versus new. There's no turning back, so what are you gonna do when that whistle blows and that whistle lies on you?
Over 80,000 tickets sold, VAR for the first time in a women's domestic football match, and Manchester United's debut appearance in an FA Cup final. It's a record-breaking kind of day. Current holders Chelsea are looking for their third FA Cup trophy in as many years, and with only 3 WSL matches remaining, they are still very much in the hunt for the double. As are their opponents, Manchester United. They've only lost twice this season in the WSL, both times against the Blues. But 17 wins in their last 20 games, and they are an informed team looking for their first major silverware. It's old versus new, it's red versus blue. Chelsea versus Manchester United in the Vitality Women's FA Cup final, and kickoff is in just over 30 minutes' time. Well, big games demand big names, and I have three of the biggest alongside me for this one: Siobhan Chamberlain, Farrah Williams and Alex Scott here to enjoy what has, it feels like, been the biggest build-up to an FA Cup final in women's football history this week. I kind of started hearing things early in the week. You normally hear something on the morning if you're kind of lucky in the past, and this today is a personification of the growth of that, a sell-out Wembley. The stars have aligned.
And that's women's football now, and I can't
can't help but already smile, because like you said, this is now becoming the norm. We don't have to keep mentioning it. If you think about the last three games here at Wembley, sold out, the Lionesses obviously the final, USA, Germany, and today, and record-breaking throughout the season if you think about the Champions League game at the Emirates. And like, this is what we're getting used to now, but this is going to be a mouth-watering final, two of the most consistent teams up against each other today.
And we were here, Farah, the last time together for that Women's Euros final last summer. A sellout Wembley then and today. Then, you know, it was a classic, England versus Germany. Today, another classic, the top two teams in the WSL.
Yeah, Chelsea versus Manchester United, as you mentioned. I think the two top teams coming into this final at Wembley. I think when I think to Wembley and the FA Cup, it's what dreams are made of. A sold-out Wembley Stadium, 90,000. It was once a dream, it's now a reality today, and I'm super excited, sat here amongst all the fans today.
Siobhan, what are you looking forward to seeing most today?
I think you're playing against two of the teams. You've got two of the teams playing here that score lots of goals. We've got a massive crowd, so I'd love to see lots of goals in the game today. Clinical players finishing in a nice high-scoring, exciting match.
Alex, we were chatting about when you played your lowest FA Cup crowd, which game it was, and 1,500 people at the Keep Moat Stadium.
Gosh, I remember I wanted to cry. I'd just come back from being a professional in America. But actually, it's now time to celebrate the growth of the game, and gone are those days. Yes, we used to play at Nottingham Forest, Selhurst Park, but this is the venue now for a Women's Cup final, as it should be.
These two teams are the top two in the WSL, but Chelsea certainly have the upper hand when it comes to the performances against each other in recent times. Nine times they've played each other, eight times Chelsea have won. And as our Chelsea representative here, you can be fair and say, well, there's kind of a reason for that, isn't there? Because Manchester United's ascent in women's football has been recent. Chelsea's history is much deeper.
Yeah, Chelsea have the bigger history, certainly in the FA Cup. We say they're 8 wins out of 9 for Chelsea and 1 draw, so United haven't beat Chelsea before. Having said that, I played in an underdog Arsenal team against Chelsea here at Wembley, and we beat them 1-0. So anything can happen when it comes to FA Cup final, the crowd, the emotion, everything that comes with that. It's a game that no one can call.
Yeah, we will dig deeper into Manchester United's recent form, don't worry, Siobhan, and just how well they have done this season to kind of break into that triumvirate and that heartland at the top of the WSL. Well, earlier in March, when they played the Conti Cup final against Arsenal, Emma Hayes and her side were beaten. Emma Hayes said that she felt her players didn't have the heart or desire to lift the trophy. Let's see how the emotions are today. Both managers have been speaking to Joe Curry.
Pernille Harder has missed large parts of this season, but she's now back from injury, she's fit, she's firing, she starts on the bench. How difficult was that conversation and what impact can she still have on this game?
No, not difficult. She's been out of a long-term hamstring injury, 3 games in the space of the week. There's a lot of football for someone who's been out for a long time. Plus, you need the impacts from the bench, so we expect P to do that for us when the time is right, but we're confident in the 11 we've selected.
You've never lost against Manchester United. From playing them twice already this season in the league, what challenges are you expecting?
Well, I thought they played us at our lowest point and they dominated the ball in that game. And arguably, you know, they felt they could have got a little more out of the game. But it's another game, it's another moment. And all I can focus on is the point we're at right now in the season, and sun's shining, the tunes are banging. Everyone looks really happy. I'm happy to be here.
Well, Mark, it's the first major cup final for the club and on the biggest stage. You said you didn't want to make today too big an occasion. How have you asked the players to manage their emotions today?
Look, I think we're going to grow maturity for the rest of our careers here today, because we're going to learn parts about ourselves that are yet to be tested. But I think the messaging this morning was about all of the kind of experiences you've had so far this season, starting with PSG in the summer in a pre-season tournament. Nobody expected us to win. We win the game. And then you go into all the big games we've played at big stadiums. And for me, it's just another opportunity for us to show our maturity, show our experience. And it's going to be a very tough game, but something we should look forward to because we've deserved to.
You've had one of the most consistent starting 11s this season. How much can that play a part today?
That can play a huge part. The reality is our team do a very good job at keeping our players on the field, so that's why it's consistent. So, it's going to be a difficult game, but those might be the determining factors later on in the game where we cohes maybe a little bit better than Chelsea. That's what we've got to hope for. But if it doesn't, we've got to find a way to adapt to try and win the final.
OK, well, you heard it there when Joe put the question to Emma Hayes. The big news for Chelsea is that Peniel Harder is still not named in the starting 11. She only returned in April following that injury she picked up in November. Sam Kerr returns after sitting out the win against Leicester with a slight knock. The Australian forward has scored in each of the last two FA Cup finals. Former Manchester United forward Lauren James keeps her place after scoring in midweek. As for Manchester United, well, four players have started every WSL match this season and they start again today. Earps, Letizier, Blundell and Toon. Captain Katie Zellum returns after missing the win against Tottenham through suspension. And two-time FA Cup winner Nikita Paris starts for her fourth consecutive game. But we'll start with the Chelsea news. Peniel Harder, a player like that, to have her on the bench is incredible. To not start her shows great confidence from Emma Hayes, doesn't it?
Great confidence in Lauren James. I think she can really use that as a boost because maybe she was thinking with Harder coming back, am I going to be starting in one of the biggest games? Will I be on the bench? But look, to have an option for this player, one of the best strikers to be coming off the bench, is going to be huge. And it might be one of those moments where she's needed to finish the game or actually see it out. But what a talent she is.
The emotion that a game like this can take out of you. Coming back from a big injury, I think starting three games in a row within a week, I think Emma Hayes mentions that, is probably too much for Harder at this point. But let's not doubt or underestimate the impact Harder can have off the bench, which I think will be bigger than what Lauren James could do if she was to come off the bench.
She's not making that impact off the bench for you. You'd like her to kind of cultivate that and add that to her game, and that would certainly be an asset for England. And a lot of these players will be thinking about that, a World Cup around the corner.
I think it's something she certainly has to add to her game. I'm not sure she's the player that Serena Wiegmann or Emma Hayes is going to play in every single game. So she has to find a way of being able to impact a game from the bench like she does when she starts games.
She's a raw talent, isn't she, Farah? And everyone knows the potential and the levels. They've seen it this season. But all of us sitting here knows there's another level and you've got to do it every single big game that you play in.
Been affected by a lot of key injuries this season. That's the injuries that will affect England potentially as well. Frank Kirby's definitely out. Millie Bright, of course, at the moment, we're not sure, but she's not there. So she's had to shuffle her pack a lot. The contrast, of course, for Manchester United is that 15 times this season, Mark Skinner has played the same starting 11. You know, he's been able, because of a lack of injuries and great fitness in this squad, to be so consistent.
Yeah, and it's a huge credit, as he's given in his interview, to the team that they've got around the team. It's really important, and to keep them all fit, it's probably one of the reasons why they're challenging at the top of the table at the moment, why they're in the FA Cup final, and why they've been able to put in the performances that they have been time and time again this season. It also makes them potentially a little bit predictable. You know what you're going to get when you play against Manchester United. They play the same lineup, same formation, but they know their jobs like the back of their hands.
Which one for the Lionesses?
You'd rather
in
have
summer.
It that way, would you?
Yeah.
You'd rather have that if you're a manager, though.
Yeah, and you build up partnerships and, you know, runs. If you look at all the goals they've scored in the WSL, they've all come from inside the penalty area. So it's like they've got their build-up play. They know where they need to be and make those runs.
Yeah, 100%. And you look at the partnerships that they've combined. Leah Galton on that left-hand side with Hannah Blundell is really important. Alessia Russo, Ella Toon. There's partnerships all over that pitch which have been cultivated throughout the season, and here is where they need to do the job.
Well, we'll dig a little bit deeper into their rise this season, and perhaps surprising some that they've managed to break in so successfully into those teams that have traditionally held those top positions a little bit later on. But first of all, we'll focus a bit more on Chelsea, because one player who was certainly secure about starting today was Sam Kerr. The Australian international is a global superstar ahead of a World Cup on home turf. We sent our superstar Alex down to have a chat.
Sam, how are you feeling? Business end of the season, lots going on.
Yeah, I'm feeling excited. I mean, I love this part of the season. I think everyone does. For the fans, the players, the coaches, this is the most exciting part.
Can we just take a moment though? Because I've just casually said, oh, lots going on. And you literally were on every part of my social media feed the other day, just casually carrying a flag, like no big deal.
Yeah, I was a bit overwhelmed, to be honest. Walking into the Abbey, it's obviously massive. It felt a bit different to walking out on the football field, especially because the Prime Minister and that was behind me. I actually thought, like, wow, I'm just like a young girl from Perth, like never, ever, ever thought of like having the opportunities that I do now and doing what I do. So I don't reflect often, but in moments like that, you kind of can't help but reflect.
going into a huge game at Wembley, another cup final against Manchester United. Have you got any superstitions going into a game like that?
How long have you got?
We've got time.
No, I'm like a weirdo with those things. I have to sit on the bus, the same set place.
I think that.
Yeah, the girls think I'm crazy. The plane, I'm on the same seat. Mm-hmm. Just little things, same dinner, same pasta sandwich before the game. That people think is disgusting.
Just plain pasta in a sandwich?
Yeah, just pasta in a sandwich.
No way.
And then if you ask our equipment manager, I drive him mad. I check all my socks, can't have any threads. Just like got to be perfection in my socks. And I've been wearing the same socks every game this season, so they're wearing thin, that's for sure.
Are you already thinking about the big moments? Because you've scored some big goals this season. Do you visualise you scoring a goal at Wembley again?
Yeah, I mean, I was doing that this morning on the way to training for sure. I also visualise like my celebrations, having fun with it. Yeah, like I think you have to as a player. I think visualisation is a big part of my game and it just gives me confidence. Like if I can see myself somewhere, then yeah, I feel like confident when I get there.
Can we just pick up on pasta sandwiches with bolognese sauce? There are sports nutritionists up and down the country watching this thinking, what have I been doing wrong? What?
It's obviously working because the amount of goals that she scores and the big goals she scores. So sometimes you don't even want to change someone's routine. Faz, are you pasta sandwich?
No, definitely not. But we used to have fish fingers, mashed potato and beans. So
fish
that's no
sandwich.
Better.
I think pre-match, some nutritionists just go, whatever it works for you. And that's clearly the case with her. And it is working. For the second season running, she is the Football Writers Player of the Year alongside Erling Haaland. She's a superstar, Alex, who is so consistent.
She really is. Top goal scorer in the WSL the last two seasons. Top scorer for Chelsea. And her ability and strength to score when it matters. I used to play with a striker, Julie Fleeting, and you know when she was on the pitch, when your team was struggling, she would come up and get you a goal. And that's the same what Sam Kerr does. She knows where she wants the ball, her strength to get in front of players, and the ability to finish on the end of things. She gave Lotte Rubenmoy a torrid time in this cup final. And it's not just the easy goals. We need to show this one because this is absolutely disgusting. Not content of just scoring an easy goal. Pop! I'm just going to pop it over your head and score a worldie in a cup final like it's the average park game and you're messing around with your mates. But Farah, she scores them all.
She does. She's a phenomenal striker. I think, you know, her biggest asset is her movement. I think for centre-half, she's an absolute nightmare to try and pick up. And she scores all types of goals. We've seen their work in the back shoulder and getting a head on it. This header here, the way she gets up in between the fullback and centre-half and just leaps and puts it into the top corner. She's been key to this Chelsea team since she signed, and somebody that on the big games, a big occasion, always comes up on top.
Well, she scored 5 in 3 FA Cups this season, 7 goals and 7 appearances against Manchester United. So she will not fear Mary Earps in nets or her defence today. And someone who's going to try and stop her today is Manchester United defender Maya Letizier. And we're just going to have a quick look at something she tweeted during the week. And this was her as a 14-year-old at Wembley. And there she is. She's shaking hands in the box with Alex Scott because we thought you were football royalty. She's a football royalty of the future. We kind of got it the wrong way around there.
I wish someone would have gave me a heads up when I was going up there. I think I was just in the moment emotional that I was finally going to lift the cup. But when she
tweeted,
part of the next gen, they were giving grants and everything as a way to encourage you to keep training because it weren't professional then, so one day you're going to make it. And actually it is what dreams come true, because like she tweeted, how times have turned around.
She's got her work cut out today and it's going to be a big test with Serena Wiegmann watching on. You know, she wants to break in and become a starter for England in the World Cup.
She definitely does. And with the number of injuries that England have got, especially defensively, it's a fantastic opportunity for her. She's going to have a tough afternoon today against Sam Kerr. But here, she reads the game really well. She recovers well as well. You see here, she's caught slightly out of position. She's young. She won't get her positioning right every time. But the ability to get back, to track back and recover is going to be key, especially as Farah said, Sam Kerr's movement is phenomenal, the way she pulls off shoulders. She'll need to recover. And this, for me, is absolutely outstanding. It's a certain goal for Beth England. She gets ahead of her, she recovers well, and makes a fantastic block, which maintains Manchester United's clean sheet. And that's what they've built on this season to give them the success that's got them to the top of the league at the moment. So for me, she's going to be key today.
Yeah, she's certainly come on, hasn't she, since she made her move from Brighton. She was under Hope Powell there, and she will be a big factor today. But we're going to turn our attention back to Chelsea now, and we're going to meet the teams with Guru Wrighton.
Sam Kerr is just the best striker in the world. She scores goals for fun.
That really is what Sam Kerr is all about.
You're not on my level!
Absolutely crazy, but she's a lot of fun. Try to take the ball away from her. I don't think anyone can because her talent and her skills are unreal. She's so strong and she got a big career in front of her.
That's a superb goal.
Kudo. I think they will say that I am the drama queen. Because I have a lot of facial expressions and a lot of arms and movements and yeah, it makes them laugh and then I'm fine with that.
Wrighton sends Corcoran the wrong way.
Erin, she got an engine that never stops.
I knew that. Oh my God.
What did you say?
I briefed you on this.
What did you want to
absolute
say?
Legend.
Okay.
Cuthbert goes for goal. Oh!
Erin Cuthbert, she's an absolute legend.
Well, out there, there are some big names watching on today. We're expecting an enormous crowd with a sellout here at Wembley. And somewhere in the thick of it is our Joe Curry.
It's amazing to think that when the Women's FA Cup final first moved here to Wembley 8 years ago, well, Manchester United's women's team didn't even exist. It means for their fans turning up today, well, they're in for a huge day out. Now, I've been joined by Charlotte and Lewis. Guys, what does it mean to finally have your women's team playing in a final and at Wembley?
We think it's great because we can actually come and watch it, and like when we've never come before, we can then just experience it at least once.
Now, you've never actually beaten Chelsea. If you're going to lift the trophy today, what needs to happen on the pitch?
We just need to play like we've like our best, and in the women's final, some people played and it was brilliant, yeah.
How difficult is today going to be, Charlotte?
Because Chelsea have won quite often, it might be harder than most teams, but if we come in with confidence, we have a good chance.
Who's your favourite player?
Alessia Russo.
Is she going to score today?
Fingers crossed.
How about you, Lewis?
Ella Toon.
Is she going to score today?
Yes.
Well, they're very optimistic here. Look, we've just got to know some of the fans. Now it's time to get to know the Manchester United team, and who knows them better than their captain, Katie Zellum.
Oh, she's going to hate me for saying this, but she's got massive faith.
Real chance, and Ella Toon has stunned the Emirates.
To be honest, I think that helps her on the pitch with her silky skills and all the assists she provides, so maybe it's a positive. She's clinical. Alessia, you put her anywhere around the box and she's going to score.
A finish of real quality from Manchester United's Alessia Russo.
Leah has the best hairstyles in the whole team and her performances speak for themselves. I think she's one of the best left wingers, not in the league, but maybe in Europe. I think for us, it's a great asset that we have Leah.
Tucked in by Leah Goldson.
Oh, what should I say about myself? I think I'm very chatty, confident, and I like to portray that in my game. I think it's important to believe in yourself. It's important to bring good energy to them around you, and hopefully I support the team well.
You have to go back to 2015 for a time when it wasn't an Arsenal, Chelsea or Manchester City who lifted a major trophy in women's football. Manchester United's breakthrough this season to be top of the WSL in this final today. Has it surprised you, Siobhan, how quickly they've risen?
To a certain extent, yes. But the club has dreams, has ambitions, has expectations. I played in the first ever game for Manchester United, I think it's 5 years ago, and we knew that it was going to be the start of something special. They had those aspirations to be up there, challenging for Champions League, challenging for the WSL, challenging for Cups. And this is what they're here out going to do today, hopefully get that first major trophy.
And look at that, they're doing it in front of a sold-out Wembley Stadium. And they're coming in with an underdog tag because of that, because of what Siobhan's explained there, that kind of five-year rise to this position today. But we shouldn't buy into that too much, should we? Mark Skinner's done something very special with the mentality.
Oh, he really has. And I think you have to credit, actually, Casey Stoney, who actually laid the foundation. She's the one that signed most of these players. And what Mark Skinner has done is taken this always, they've been a promising team, and actually made them start believing. I think they were drawing too many games last season. That was their downfall. So the games against the likes of Aston Villa and Everton this season, they are picking up points and they believe that they can win on this stage.
Barry, you want to have a look at a really key battleground for you, which is the number 11s, Guru Wrighton and Leah Galton.
We so often compare players. I actually just want to highlight how important both of these players are for their team. Guru Wrighton for Chelsea, who plays down the left, and Leah Galton. I think they both have similar attributes in terms of what they like to do. You can see here, Galton comes off the left, finds an assist and finds her teammate. What they both like to do is go on the outside. Certainly Guru Wrighton, she's got a phenomenal left foot, and her delivery to find a teammate within the box is exceptional. She just does a little give and go. This is trademark Guru Wrighton, a little dink to the back post. And who is she looking for? Her teammate Sam Kerr. And this is a consistent for Guru Wrighton and this Chelsea team throughout the season. And you can just see here, Leah Galton just anticipating that pass back. But the finish is exceptional. The way she just uses the outside of her left foot to bend it. This is a perfect picture. She just bends it around the goalkeeper. An outstanding finish. So I'm really excited to see both of these two players impact the game for their team, because I think whichever one of those two players play well, their team wins today at Wembley. But here's the Guru Wrighton, another one through the central, and then just finish it. Really, really good, Alex.
Yeah, most assists this season as well, so you know the impact that she's going to have. And actually for Manchester United, the fullback, the Spanish fullback, Batier, she has had a huge impact, and she's actually one of the most assisted players. What, 9 assists this season?
She's been outstanding. And for me, Farah says about Leah Galton or Guru Wrighton, for me, if Ona Badje gets high up the pitch and can start delivering balls into the box, she's key for Manchester United in winning this game.
It is such an exciting prospect, isn't it, this one? But two United players who know all about playing here at Wembley in front of a sellout crowd are, of course, Alessia Russo and Ella Toon. So this time, we sent Siobhan to take them both on.
Right, talking of FA Cup final, obviously Wembley, both of you have had some amazing special memories there. How special will it be there in a Manchester United shirt?
Yeah, I think the FA Cup is what you watch as a little kid. You watch the stories that it tells through the teams working their way to the final. And I think for us to be at the final, it's our first chance at a major trophy. And I think that we're feeling good and raring to get there and get going now.
Here goes Russo!
We've had some good times at Wembley with our country. And Wembley is the home of English football and everyone wants to go and play there. So for us then to go with the club, especially the club that we've grown up supporting as well, it makes it that bit more special.
Plays it through to Toon to try and make it 2, and so she does.
I think it's special for our fans too to have an opportunity to come down to Wembley. I think they follow us up and down the country week in, week out, and now it's time for them to enjoy their day, and we've got to go out there and put on a performance that we're proud of and that makes them proud too.
Right, I've got a question for you. You scored 2 worldies at Wembley. You threw on goal, you look up, you see Les to your left. Do you pass or do you shoot?
Is she offside or what? You know what, if I'm in on goal and I know I'm scoring, I'm scoring. If I know that the keeper's going to save it and the best thing to do is to square it, I'm squaring it. So depends on the moment.
Maybe you'll lob her.
Yeah, maybe
you
I'll
like
just
that.
Chip it over.
The only losses have come to Chelsea. Going into a final against them, does that play on your mind at all?
We don't ever dwell on performances in the past. We only ever look forward and we know what we have to do to beat this Chelsea side. And for us, it's just about focusing on ourselves and what's got us here so far this season, and obviously going out there and just putting on a performance and really believing in ourselves.
two superstars, super subs, weren't they, last summer, who have now become mainstays and household names. So important for United.
Really important. Their link-up play, and when Toon gets on the ball, she's looking for the run of Russo as well. And they're used to it now, having these big games, having knowing that pressure's on them to deliver. So I don't think they feel that as a player. And can I just say, Faz, if I was stronger, I'd pass to you, you know.
That's what I never made as a striker.
Well, Chelsea today are going for yet another double, but could there be a change in the Wembley air?
Chelsea rule once again.
Royalty. Blue is the colour.
A dynasty that shows no sign of ending.
Double shots only.
Red, a city of changemakers.
Manchester United have done it.
Where there's a first time for everything.
It's their first major final in their history.
Blue Bloods or a Red Revolution. The Women's FA Cup Final.
Emma Hayes said banging tunes. I can tell you the atmosphere in here today is banging, Farah.
What's banging, Gabby? Is that you use the word banging?
It is absolutely brilliant to see the top tier there with almost full at the moment. The flags there are going, the blues, the reds of Wembley. The atmosphere, Alex, is exactly the kind of atmosphere that women's football have been crying out for, to show their talents and their wares. And these women who are in that tunnel right now are not going to have to be fazed by this. This is something they're going to have to get used to. And many of them have already. They played at Wembley in Euros finals, but it still gives you butterflies in your tummy.
It does. And I cannot help but sit here and smile, because we all know, we all knew women's football could get to this stage, and here we are. And actually, it's now the norm. This is women's football. We're here to enjoy it, and you've got two of the best teams contesting to lift that cup today.
We saw Mary Earps there. She was the FIFA Keeper of the Year last year. She's played in a Euro and won a Euro final. But even somebody like her, you know, this occasion, when you go out, you have to take the emotion. You have to put it somewhere else on a day like today, Siobhan.
You do, but you kind of want that little bit of nerves. Like Alex said, those butterflies, they help you perform to the best of your ability. You want to be on the edge of your seat, excited, ready to go.
And the crowds are ready for this. They can't wait to see this final, the top two in the WSL. The expectation is that Chelsea, Farah, have got to live up to, you know, winning doubles. They're going for their third double in a row. Manchester United want to spoil the party.
Yeah, of course United want to come here and spoil Chelsea's party. Chelsea, I think from the outside, everybody expects them to win this FA Cup here today and to win the WSL. There's huge pressure on them to do that. They've had a lot of games coming into this fixture today, so it's going to be a difficult one. I can't call it. I'd love to sit here and say Chelsea are going to win it, but honestly, for the first time, I can't call this FA Cup final.
Are we going all the way? Are we going to extra time today, Alex? Is it that hard to call this one, do you feel? Or can you see somebody pipping this? Is there a player there? You said Sam Kerr, potentially. Leo Galton. Who's going to make the difference today?
To be honest, Gabby, I think it's those individuals, every single one of them, needing to win their individuals. Whoever comes out on top will win it. Look how special that is as well.
It is very special indeed, isn't it? This is the fourth successive match at Wembley Women's Football to have a sellout crowd, and there he is, His Royal Highness, the Prince of Wales, Prince William, who is meeting the players, being led out, of course, and seeing that happen, Alex. You know, this wasn't always the case. You got used to that in the men's game, but there wasn't always royal representation for the women's finals.
It really is. It's so special. But as we spoke about before, actually, Mark Skinner mentioned it in the lead-up to this when he was here with Birmingham. It's about removing some of that emotion. So, yes, it's special, but it's business today.
Well, he's been there with Magdalena Eriksson, but now Mark Skinner will take him along the line to meet his women, and Katie Zellin will take him down there. And this is a moment that players should try and savour, but at the same time, as Alex says, your mind's somewhere else.
Of course, but the Prince, you know, is a huge fan of women's football. He's been there over the years. I remember as an international, Alex, and Siobhan, we received messages from the Prince when we was in tournament. So he's a huge fan of the women's game. It's phenomenal for, you know, to see the Prince out here today with both teams.
Well, we'll shortly hear the anthem sung by Jasmine Faulkner, a British Iranian soprano, and then we will leave you in the company for this one of our commentary team today, Rachel Brown-Finnis and Robin Cowan. But now a moment to savour for the sellout crowd here at Wembley, the national anthem.
Another weekend and another historic occasion for women's football. A sold-out Wembley Stadium hosts the top two teams in the country in the 2023 FA Cup Final. Will it be the reigning champions Chelsea who lift the trophy for the third consecutive year? Or will it be first-time finalist Manchester United who can break Chelsea's domestic dominance? So many subplots rolled into one. It's set to be a captivating afternoon at the National Stadium. Three changes to the Chelsea side have beaten Leicester 6-0 in midweek. Maren Mielde is preferred to Jess Carter in the back line. Jesse Fleming comes into the midfield for Jelena Jankovic. And Sam Kerr, who was not involved in midweek, returns in place of Pernille Harder in the forward line. She scored 9 goals in 6 cup finals for Chelsea, including a brace in the previous 2 in the FA Cup. One change from the win over Spurs for United. Captain Katie Zellum returns from suspension. She's one of 4 Manchester United players in the squad who have been there since their formation in 2018. Mary Earps, top scorer Alessia Russo, Nikita Paris and Ella Toon all appeared at Wembley for England's Euro 2022 victory over Germany. Toon has scored on each of her last 2 international appearances here, including in the Finalissima last month. Rachel Brown finished. You wanted to focus on the 2 number 9s for Chelsea and Manchester United this afternoon.
Good afternoon, Robin. Sam Kerr in our picture there. The number 9 for Chelsea. Goals galore, scored absolute beauties on this very pitch as well for Chelsea in the cup final, FA Cup final last year. I'll be looking to lead her team to glory this summer in the World Cup in Australia on her home turf. And yes, number 9 for Manchester United, Alessia Russo, had success on this pitch in the summer and been absolutely desperate to replicate that for a club.
The referee Emily Heaslip chosen to officiate this game, and in preparation has been part of a group of referees taking part in an extensive VAR training for this occasion. For the first time, we do have a video assistant referee in Stockley Park in Michael Salisbury.
I'm looking forward to seeing that combination of Ella Toon and Alessia Russo. We saw a devastating effect in the summer with the Lionesses. Plenty of Lionesses fans here in the stands, not just Chelsea, not just Manchester United, but Lionesses fans here, eager to see their superstars of the summer. And I know I've highlighted the number 9s, but Mary Earps in goal. One of those successful Lionesses player. Best goalkeeper in the world, and she's going to need to have a worldie today as underdogs for Manchester United.
It is the top two sides currently in the country. The old veterans against the young pretenders. Call it what you want. It is one of the most anticipated fixtures in the calendar. Let's hope it lives up to the hype. The players take the knee and we are underway. Although a false start, we'll have to go again. Blue against red. Chelsea will kick us off and they start the game as favourites, going for their third consecutive FA Cup and their 4th in their history. For Manchester United, the first FA Cup final they are contesting, but they have only had a senior team since 2018. Here is Ella Toon for Manchester United. Goes for the early ball in towards Goulton! 20 seconds on the clock! The flag is up! Well, we do have VAR. This will be checked. Drama already at Wembley.
What a start, though, regardless when it's given. Oh, offside. Yeah. What a build-up, though. Lovely little setback from Nikita Paris. Ona Bagé. Yeah, you can just see it's been looped around the corner by Alessia Russo to Ella Toon. It is offside. It's that ball from her to Ella Toon.
Russo's going to latch onto this. What a brilliant start for the red side. They are rattling Chelsea. That was inches offside. Lauren James draws the foul.
Ella Toon down there. She's the one who just strayed slightly offside, and why the decision was made for the goal. It wasn't Galton who put it in the empty net. And here, Lauren James back doing her defensive duties. Quarter on the back, but the initial contact was Lauren James and Ella Toon. Not much in it, but Emma Hayes is going to need even Lauren James to be tracking back. As attacking brilliant she is. I'll tell you what, Ella Toon might be down in the first or second minute, but she will not be coming off.
Already perhaps a costume change needed, a rip of the shorts. Electric opening.
Exactly what Mark Skinner will have wanted. Sometimes that first goal in a huge energy-sapping competition like this can be the decider.
Mark Skinner led his Birmingham City side to the FA Cup final back in 2017. A heavy defeat to Manchester City on that occasion. Also very different attire, like he was getting married that day.
Oh, do you know what?
Three-piece suits and
get better with ages, Mr. Skinner. Doing very well. But do you know what? What the girls alluded to in the studio beforehand, all of us have played in cup finals, who are talking about it. There's never been such an even cup final, in my opinion, between these two teams. There's never a game that you've gone into where you expect one particular team to dominate. So it's teed up to be such an exciting afternoon.
As mentioned in the build-up, Manchester United have never beaten Chelsea. This is the 10th meeting for today. 8 wins for Chelsea and 1 draw. And they go long towards Sam Kerr. The flag has stayed down for now. That looked a tight one. Kerr trying to pull it back. Eventually, that's gone up very, very belatedly.
Now, my initial instinct was that Sam Kerr had strayed just a fraction offside. See here, Benzer tries to bend a run yet and just leaning her shoulder. Very well disciplined backline, Millie Turner. The assistant just took her time with giving it as per the protocol.
A 1-0 win for Chelsea at King's Meadow against Manchester United a couple of months ago. They really showed they can switch it up. They had very little possession, they went direct, and that was how they got Manchester United that time. So they've really got to contend with a team that has a lot of different tactical tools in their armoury.
Yeah, I agree, and especially down that left-hand side, Onabaje is the more attacking of the two full-backs for Manchester United and might leave the gap for Sam Kerr to exploit. I just saw that.
Good pressure from Hayley Ladd, drawing the mistake from Jessie Fleming.
Yeah, what a good pairing, Hayley Ladd and Katie Zalamar, in the heart of the Manchester United midfield. Defensive dirty work from Ladd, and not just that, excellent discipline and shape. Katie Zalam certainly got that defensive element, but has absolute brilliance, right and left foot. Set pieces.
Millie Turner has played an FA Cup final for Everton back in 2014. Two. Beautiful flick to Galton, who's got a bit of space to run into here. Plays it forward, Paris and Toon getting in each other's way there. Paris keeps hold of it. Good movement from Zellum. Paris too strong for Leopolds. Toon against Mara Mialda might get the chance here to square the ball back to Katie Zellum. Good pressure this from United. Zellum delivers, and the punch from Anne-Catherine Berger ricocheted off a Manchester United player. It's out for a goal kick.
All the pressure is Man United. Nikita Paris again involved in the build-up, did really well to recycle the ball and set it back to Katie Zellum. Left-footed, This wasn't too far away. Not the most convincing of goalkeeping. When you're coming like that, you need to get some height on it. And Katzenberger punches it straight onto the head of Russo. Nikita Paris, both the right-hand side for that offside goal. She set that back to start that attack. Over on the left-hand side.
A cliche it might be, but when you are the so-called underdogs, you need to take these chances when you are on top, because a team like Chelsea can punish you. A lot of space here, no one closing down Ladd. Neither Ella Toon, lovely drop of the shoulder. Hops to find Katie Zellum, and now Badger getting forward. That was well read by Neve Charles. Completes the clearance.
Yeah, it's felt like one phase of attack too many, didn't it? Going back out to that side to Onabaje. They had the opportunity and a ball to pull the trigger almost there with Ella Toon and Central. Mark Skinner will be delighted though with his team start.
It's picked up by Letizia, just straight out of play. Skinner named Barclays WSL Manager of the Month for April.
It's Lopez who's down.
And the Leupolds on the deck. Demahayes, who's seen her team return to form with a couple of thumping victories back to back in the WSL, scoring 13 goals against Everton and Leicester, but clearly giving some stern instructions after a bit of a slow start from her team.
Yeah, they've done well really to ride it, because they certainly got to the back front in the first 20 seconds. Some players like Millie Bright desperate to get back for the end of the season, which is, you know, only a couple of games now off with Chelsea, but certainly with the longer-term target, which is only a couple of months of the World Cup this summer. I mean, Leupolz, what an inspiration she is. Having had a child back in October, back on the pitch. It just shows you that people think you can't have children and be a professional athlete as a female. Well, there you go. Absolute prime example of having the right support, building the right support, making the right support. And she's been key to Emma Hayes' plans since she's come back.
She looks in a bit of discomfort. We'll have to see if she can continue. She started 5 out of the last 6 before today, Leupolz. As you say, has been key. That double pivot with Erin Cuthbert. Fantastic pass from Earps.
Brilliant decision making, first of all. So the quick press, had to readjust. Spotted a first option, wasn't free. Went second option. Beautiful crisp pass as well from Mary Earps. Take that for granted, but there's a lot that went into that execution of that pass.
So Tissier. Engel getting some instructions just in case she has to replace Leupolz.
Yeah, if that was the case, then it's a like-for-like swap. So Engel, many a year at Chelsea, many a trophy with them. They just fit straight in alongside Erin Cuthbert.
James helps it on to Sam Kerr. Plays it through for Lauren James, who knows she's offside, so she's encouraging the teammate to get forward. Oh, the flag hasn't gone up. And eventually it has.
It's frustrating, isn't it, for the fans, for the players, when it's a really obvious one. Just put the flag up. Then we go into territory of, is she interfering? Of course she's interfering. Put the flag up. Still hasn't happened.
inviting Neve Charles to do a sprint that wasn't rewarded in the end.
Start the whole debate again, but yeah, it invites other factors or other incidents that potentially could happen that could have been stemmed at the point when the assistant put the flag up. Turner back in, centre-half pairing, placed a couple of games by Aoife Mannion, coming back from a long-term injury, centre-half.
And that was certainly one of the decisions that Mark Skinner had to make as Russo goes down, but referee unmoved. The ball is played back to Katrin Berger under pressure from Paris. Lovely control, and again, United enthusiastic in getting to the ball and maybe a lack of communication. James puts it out for a United throw.
Yeah, with the condensed schedule that Chelsea have had, Emma Hayes has had to make changes across the midfield, across the whole team, not just for this one game, but for the populated calendar that she's had in this last 2 or 3 weeks particularly.
Perisse closed down now. Berger quick off her line to claim. There goes Neve Charles in a bit of space.
Good retreat by Nikita Paris. It's an excellent break from Katrin Berger. Looking to start an early attack. Kelly Wrighton's been so key, hasn't she, to Chelsea this season. Was an ever-present, a link-up play with the forward, a set pieces, corners. A special player.
Chelsea's depth has taken a hit this season. The likes of Gura Wrighton and Sam Kerr have had to shoulder the burden. The absence of Frank Kirby and Pernilla Harder, who is named on the bench today. There is Hannah Blundell, formerly of Chelsea, two times FA Cup winner with the Blues. Perisse into Fleming and now Kerr. Cuthbert forced back and again United win it back in a good position. Goulton left by Russo. Here is Toon running into traffic a little bit, finds Nikita Paris, found the gap, but straight at Berger.
When Manchester United switch into attack mode, when they turn over possession, there's three, four players forwards, that front three rotating and swivelling. Been so fluid, Ella Toon joining in as a fourth in the line of attack. Just can't, it's excellent defending from Chelsea. They get really compact, really tight. Keith Parrish just can't open that hip up enough to angle it into the far corner. Seen a couple of games prior to this last two where Ella Toon's not featured at all, and she played a freer role in the last game at the weekend against Spurs and was much more effective. It's the same tonight. She seems to be finding herself in pockets of space and be elusive to mark.
Cuthbert closed down and then gets the decision. What a big boost it is for Chelsea to have Pernilla Harder back, missing for a number of months with a hamstring injury, and has been back with a bang. Braces in her last two appearances in the WSL.
That is something you do not want to see coming on, 70, 75, 80 minutes into a Wembley FA Cup final on a warm afternoon if you are a Manchester United player. She's a real thoroughbred, Pernilla Harder.
Can't quite keep that one in.
She finds herself free on so many occasions. It's with Neve Charles pushing high up, trying to attack. There is that option of gambling, finding the space in advance.
ever since they were founded in 2018 as a senior women's team. Manchester United have had a healthy following, vocal support. They could become the first team since Liverpool in 2014 to win a domestic trophy. Pulling away and getting a free kick right on the edge. Hannah Blundell questioning the decision.
Hannah Blundell, formerly of Chelsea, almost became surplus requirements. Thought stuck with Lauren James exceptionally well. Lauren James was definitely going down already. If there was any contact on the back of her calves, she certainly made the most of it, but advantageous position for her team she has gained.
Well, Manchester United had an excellent defensive record from set pieces, but that was shattered against Aston Villa and Rachel Daly in the WSL. Here's Perisay, flicked towards goal by Mielder, couldn't quite get enough on it. Picked up by Russo, who's assessing her options, doesn't have too much in the way of support forward.
You can see the intention though. Ella Toon had shot straight up the pitch from the camp to try and gain the counter-attack. She's here on the byline, ready for the left foot in-swinger. Dealt with really well, but you see Ella Toon get on a bike and absolutely bombs forward. Excitement opening 18 minutes.
Chelsea's second cup final of the season. They lost in the Continental Cup against Arsenal at Selhurst Park back in February. Set forward by Eriksen. Euro Wrighton's going to put some pressure on Badger. He deals with it, her usual composure. Harris, though, gives it away, but wins it back. Fantastic strength from Nikita Paris to draw the challenge.
Don't mind if you give up possession like Nikita Paris did, as long as you get the reaction exactly like Nikita Paris gave. Determination to get your body between the ball and the player, initiate the foul and get possession back for your team.
Offside flag off against Nikita Paris.
Yeah, straight, just a step, I would say, ahead. Flag went straight up. She has been hungry today, she's been wonderful. Been impressed so far with the movement of that front three. Chelsea have been here before. They're quite happy to play second fiddle for long spells if that's what it takes to win a game, and they know how and when. Minster, that sucker punch.
Ticket was sold today at Wembley. We'll wait to see what the attendance is. We could have another record on our hands for the women's domestic match.
Well, I've been counting, Robin, there's definitely over 49,000, which there was for the last FA Cup final. Just not quite got beyond that, and they're counting yet.
Very impressive. I would have run out of fingers and toes by now. Busy week for His Royal Highness, Prince of Wales, involved in the coronation last weekend. Of course, will be involved in crowning the winner today. Turner's header to Katie Zellum. That bright start just petered out a little bit, the ebb and flow of a cup final.
You walk down that tunnel and that surge of adrenaline and energy.
Toon released that just in time. Badger unopposed into the penalty area, trying to pick out Russo. A vital touch from the elder. Eriksson clears, flicked on towards Sam Kerr. Holds it up beautifully. Lundell will just about get there ahead of Lauren James.
Excellent positioning from Hannah Blundell and excellent speed from her as well. She read the situation beautifully.
Man United with the composure to play it out from the back, and they are out. High risk can mean high reward.
Do you know, you can play that when you've got the accuracy of passes, but you've also got the movement off the ball to be in position to receive it, but to be able to play it first time as well. Definite foul. From Perisset on Russo. But see how quickly and easily both teams can cut open the back lines. United had an attack, we're in the final third, and within seconds Sam Kerr turned it over, the ball through to Lauren James.
Blondell spotting the run of Paris, good idea, an intelligent bit of play from Paris to make the run. Here is Leopold, the German international. Five times a French Cup winner, Bordeaux and Paris Saint-Germain. Chelsea searching for their 12th major trophy. They've also won here at Wembley Community Shield back in 2020. Display of great passing from the goalkeeper, all over the top for Kerr. That's where she likes it.
Yeah, great starting position though from Mary Epps to counter that. That's what, along with everything technically, Mary Epps has improved on. The tactical side, the recognition of patterns of play, how things build up, what's the likely outcome going to be, and get your starting position based on that, reading scenarios.
Good win from Eriksson. And more to come as we reach the business end of the season. A huge game between Chelsea and Arsenal for you next weekend, 12:15 on BBC One. And the final day, 27th of May, Saturday, 2:30 kickoff every single game. Still TBC because the title race, the race for the Champions League and relegation, still very much alive. Russo backing in, wants the decision. Nicely played by Zellum.
the owner Bagé just thinking about her still wondering whether to sign an extension or sign a new contract, sorry, solidified as that third minimum guaranteed Champions League spot, I'm hoping, and Manchester United fans will be hoping that'll be the deal breaker for Alessio Russo to sign new contracts this summer.
Here is Russo wriggling away from a couple of challenges. You see what she was trying to do, but good tracking back from James to intercept that pass towards Blundell. But yes, could be an interesting summer for Manchester United. Could lose two of their biggest players in Badger and Alessio Russo. It's also rumoured that Chelsea will lose Eriksen and Vanilla Harder as well. So it could be a lot of turnover for both of these teams. Letizia clearing up. Here is James. Anticipation always increases when she's on the ball. Goes for the early cross in.
And again, Hannah Blundell does so well. So Marshall gets so tight, matches her stride for stride. With too many defenders who know Lauren James. And in fact, the whole Chelsea team as much as Hannah Blundell does. So Russo dropping deeper and deeper to try and get on the ball for Man United. I want to see her higher up.
Poles this time.
Mary Epps has the sunshine to deal with this half. Katzenberger doesn't, just from a goalkeeper's point of view, that's not preferable.
Middleton closed down. She had the ball in the back of the net after just 20 seconds. Flagged offside. She has been the informed player for Manchester United in front of goal. Five in her last five in all competitions.
Find Leah Galton was. Casey Stoner as Manchester United manager, bringing her back in. Refinding a love of football, Leah Galton. She's been absolutely so key to that attack.
Paris thought about a shot. Waits for support from Badger. Two. Linking up the play, finding Nikita Paris. Nearly. Towards Ella Toon. A bit sloppy from Chelsea as they try and work their way out. Manchester United closing them down quickly and winning it back.
That's it. It's Chelsea have not got any time on the ball. It has to be perfect. And Manchester United are hustling them.
Tissier. Again, Paris making the run. Just bounces away from her.
It was the right idea, wasn't it? Right run, well timed from Nikita Paris. Lovely little turn from Katie Zellum. Tricks. Initiates contact. Fleming getting a lot frustrated that they can't keep possession, Chelsea. Back in after having a ban, Katie Zellum.
Charles did well to get past Nikita Paris, but she's given it straight back to United. Foul given. Zellum caught late.
With the fact that we've not mentioned Erin Cuthbert until this point where she's on camera, to this point, just shows you how much Manchester United are stopping her playing. So Erin Cuthbert is one of the players of the season for Chelsea and has been previously. A sniff in this game.
Letizia playing in the FA Cup final after presenting the trophy to Arsenal in 2016 as a 14-year-old, giving it to our very own Alex Scott. Left it for Katie Zellum, who's one of the best with the dead ball in the league. It's an awkward one. Bodies flying everywhere. Turner! Berger makes the save.
What a save that was from Katzenberger. What a chance. Willie Turner popped up with a goal. Header, last minute header. On a comeback. This time it's the second phase. Drops down. Great adjustment from Ann Katzenberger in the Chelsea goal. See here as Millie Turner finds herself in a little bit of space. Snapshot, deflection. Oh, off Mjelde. Thankfully the pace was taken off of the ball with that deflection, but still a great reaction save from Ann Katzenberger. But she's going the other way. Has to power off. And she's down, injured now, Ann Katzenberger.
Goalkeeper and defender Mjelde down for Chelsea. So might take this opportunity to reset once again. Mary Earps has had very little to do. Big chances have fallen to Manchester United past the half-hour mark.
Yeah, it's been routine stuff for Mary Earps. Starting position, ensuring that that is perfect and done that prevents her having to make any saves, but Mark Skinner will definitely be the happier of the two. Emma Hayes knows her team have been on the back foot, they've not been sharp in midfield. Katzenberger just signalling there, saying she's going to be okay. It'll be interesting to see, we're talking before the game, whether Lauren James would start, and if she did, would she stay on, because she's started every single game pretty much this season until latterly. You just see it's that extension of Ann Katzenberger's arm. You can just hyperextend it. It'll land a bit awkwardly, but it'll take more than that to have to get her off the pitch today.
I was going to say, you'll have to drag her off. She was also part of Mark Skinner's Birmingham team in 2017. They lost the final, making the move to Chelsea. Vastly experienced and nominated for the FIFA Best Goalkeeper, which went to her opponent today, Mary Earps. Two of the best, though, on the pitch. Here is James. Manchester United players not allowing Chelsea to take the free kick quickly. Just a talking to from Emily Heisler.
Well, it's clearly been a tactic, hasn't it, on Mark Skinner's side? Stifle Chelsea, don't let them rest easy in possession, hurry them on the ball.
Lerpholz. United still closing down those passing channels. James. Blundell, aware of the challenge ahead of her. At the moment, she is doing a brilliant job of stifling Lauren James. Not an easy job.
A little bit of afters there between Blundell and Lauren James. Try on that one. Real sharpness and polished edge to the game, Manchester United, so far in this opening, with whether it be comfortable in possession at the back like this, or whether it be those sweeping moves forwards. Certainly not the fresher of the two teams.
They have had a whole week to prepare. Chelsea had that midweek game against Leicester and another one before that against Everton. Because of their commitments in Europe, they've been playing catch-up, but they still have the title in their hands. Two games to go. If they win both of them, No matter what Manchester United do, they will pit them to the post. Paris onto Alessio Russo. Pulls it back and Golton over the top. Slightly awkward one for Golton, but another presentable chance for Manchester United.
Wonderful move, and it comes again from that rotation of the front three. This time Alessio Russo out on that right-hand side. Golton coming more central. Ella Toon backing her up, little deflection. Oh. And she just flicks her foot out. Great run to the near post, gets across a defender, Leah Golton. Oh, and it's everything but seeing that back of the net bustle.
James, surrounded, still keeps hold of it. A little bit behind Charles, starting her first cup final. Pressure. From Zellum, a little bit too much on Erin Cuthbert.
Too much with that, Katie Zellum. But you can see the intention when United lose possession of the ball. Try and win it back first and foremost, but do it together. Hunting packs.
Kerr wins the header. Tissier with the clearance. Poles keeps hold of it for Chelsea. Here's Perisic. James forced inside. Charles. Now Wrighton. Defended from Badger.
Badger and Blundell are matching Wrighton. James down the flanks. Have to find a different way of breaking them down and going on the outside for Chelsea.
Tissier didn't get good contact on the clearance, but Turner made up for it. Back with Chelsea and Perisic. James once again getting acquainted with Blundell.
Good contest, hasn't it, down this side, this near side to us, between those two. But I've played in cup finals, FA Cup finals before, and you cannot switch off for a fraction of a second, because that's when the best of the best players get one over on you. Blundell will know that. Every single one of these players out there will know that.
Cuthbert. Again. Forced back. United in a good shape. Forcing Chelsea away from their own goal. Five minutes until the break. Energetic first half from Manchester United. The question is, will they be able to keep it up? Kerr gets away from Millie Turner. A couple of options in the middle. Fleming on the edge. Advantage played by the referee. James gets ahead to it and clawed out of the goal by Mary Earps. The closest Chelsea have come by far.
What a save, Mary Earps. I think she clattered herself on the post. I'll tell you why this is so good, because you look at the angle, it's actually comes off Millie Turner. She has to get herself from the one side of the goal, Mary Earps. See how it redeflects it all the way across. Her feet get going so quick, she times it to perfection so that she can power off and make that save. See there, she's at a near post, she gets her feet moving super quick. For any young goalkeeper out there, most of us females especially, are not going to be 6 foot five. We're not going to be able to rely on a huge reach. Footwork is the key. Brilliant from Mary Earps.
That would have been a fortuitous opening for Chelsea. Mary Earps on hand.
She takes a huge pride in clean sheets, doesn't she, Mary Earps?
Comfort.
13 clean sheets this season.
Kerr closing down. Again, calmly done. Blundell. Really good play. Russo. On to Galton. Numbers coming forward now. Away by Eriksson. Badger. Still going. Oh no. Eventually, the referee has given a foul.
There's a huge shoot. Sigh from our right, which is where big wall of red is sat. Manchester United fans, they want their team to pull the trigger a couple of times on the edge of the box. They've had that yard of space. Closed down really well, actually, by Erin Cuthbert there. Barcelona and Manchester City who have stopped Chelsea scoring this season.
You were right and frustrated this time. Approaching half time. There have been an abundance of chances, but most of them have fallen. The players in red.
Yeah, he won't be too ready to shuffle his pack to change. He doesn't change his starting 11 too much, Mark Skinner. He's tried and tested substitutes of Rachel Williams, who's come on to be a difference, number nine, who's been here on this Wembley pitch before. The 2012 Olympics in front of a record-breaking crowd, as it was at the time.
Current Manchester United owner is in. Lengthy protests, I should say. It's the change of ownership. Less than imminent, it seems. Always a big question as to how that will affect the women's team. Whenever there's a change of hands, Chelsea have had that recently.
I don't think it's going to affect teams like this anything other than benefit them. Support is here and it's here to stay now.
Fleming dispossessed. Bit of space here for Neve Charles. Finds right and inside. The dummy. On to Jessie Fleming, pursued by Turner, cleared by Hayley Ladd. 3 minutes of added time, the end of the first half. This is Lauren James.
Chelsea know that United sapped a little bit of energy. Capitalise on that.
Fleming. Trying to find Kurt. Just whips away from her head.
The clean sheets this season in the WSL are not just down to Mary Earps. She's huge, very, very high standards, but that back line has been largely unchanged. Other Millie Turner dropping out for a couple of games and Aoife Mannion coming in. And that's a key part, really, to why so stingy with giving up goals. They take a huge pride in it and they rehearse it exceptionally well.
Also wins the flick on, and that's an error from Eriksson. Swing and a miss Harris onto it straight away. Twisting and turning and trying to get away from Neve Charles. And a free kick again right on the edge of the penalty area, this time for Manchester United. Chelsea had one in a similar position. That looked close, I've got to say.
This is what Nikita Paris has always been exceptional at. Played with her at England level and at Everton level. That, for me, is a penalty. She's given it as a free kick, the referee. Nikita Paris, lovely tight turn. It's on the line, in the box. Just there, in the box, penalty.
Well, this is going to be looked at, and it has been looked at by the video assistant referee, Michael Salisbury. Check complete, and it stays a free kick. Did it start outside the box?
What a contact start outside the box, but the foul for me is in the box, but United have got a great chance.
Zellum delivers. Billy Turner rose, but couldn't keep the header down.
Great chance, lovely ball from Zellum, and just like Millie Turner, came on as a late sub against Aston Villa to score the winner. Rose at the back post, she was a target. Up between two Chelsea defenders, she rose the tallest. Been played in that FA Cup final with me back in 2014.
Half time, goalless, but Manchester United will feel they should be ahead. Leah Galton had the ball in the back of the net inside the first 30 seconds. It was ruled offside. Millie Turner has had a couple of opportunities. Chelsea have looked a little flat so far, but we know they can dig something out from absolutely nowhere. They are champions for a reason. Still all to play for in the second half. In the FA Cup final 2023 here at Wembley. Half time, Chelsea 0, Manchester United 0.
Well, after a half like that, you would ordinarily say Mark Skinner will feel the happier. His team had the better chances, but actually, Siobhan Chamberlain, you know, the pattern of the season is that Chelsea will let you in for periods of the game. They are going to come back and bite you, though, and to come away and not have got anything from those chances will be enormously frustrating for the Manchester United manager.
I think frustration is the word. He will be frustrated because they had opportunities. The most brilliant start possible if that goal had been allowed, but they have created, and I think they've got to take the positives from that. But we talk about clinicalness, ruthlessness, that's what you need against Chelsea.
But let's start with the very last move of the match, or the half, sorry, let's hope it's not the match. The penalty shout, Alex, there. You were happy with the decision ultimately.
Over in the end, it's so close, but when you go back and you see the replays, which allows us that. But initially, Nikita Paris has been having a great game. She's so lively and the energy that she's bringing, and this is what she's good at, taking you on 1v1 and getting herself into the box. So initially, we're all shouting, penalty, penalty. But I think when you see the clip, the initial tackle is on her back foot outside the box that then takes her in, if we see another angle of it.
I was shouting from up here, it was literally right below us, and initially I thought it's a penalty, she's caught her inside the box. Nikita's done really well to find a way to get herself on the ball inside the box, clumsy from Childs. But as Alex said there, on the replay, she catches her back foot, which is outside the box, and she actually falls just here.
Just there, yeah.
And then she falls into the box. So correct decision from the referee.
First ever FA Cup, Women's FA Cup final with VAR, and it's been put to use. It was put to use with inside a minute, of course, as well. But let's go back on a save from Berger, which was possibly the best chance, Alex, for United.
It really was. And Manchester United have been the better team in this game so far, but we all know it's not the best team that always goes on to win the games. But Chelsea have needed their keeper to come up big. But United haven't let Chelsea get a sniff of anything. They've reacted to everything. But Sayo, you need to come in here and talk about the goalkeeper, because it's a great reaction save.
It's a brilliant save, and you can think the ball's moving quite slowly, so it might look a little bit easier. But she's already on the move. She's already on her way down. So to be able to adjust her feet at that deflection and still claw it around the post is a phenomenal save.
I think it's the way she's able to shift her weight. If you look at her right foot, it's planted as if she's going to her right-hand side. To be able to shift that weight across and get a big hand on it from the goalkeeper, phenomenal save.
And another good chance there as well, Alex.
They've really started on the front foot, Manchester United, pressing Chelsea in every area, getting down the wide areas and creating these chances. We said most of their goals come from inside the penalty area, getting those crosses in and working on those all types of movements. And it's been working for them in the first half.
For a team that have never lifted the FA Cup, it was almost the dream start, wasn't it? Inside a minute, it took our breath away.
It was almost an unbelievable start, is what dreams are made of. To score so early, they set out their ambition. They pressed Chelsea immediately. They were on the front foot, they committed bodies. And here the pass, Ella Toon on the turn here, just straight, inches offside. But Leah Galton showing how dangerous she is, being a presence in the box, and that's why she scored so many goals. This pass there on that turn, she was just slightly offside. But it shows what Manchester United can do. And as you said, it could have been the brilliant start.
Though, it really was tight, wasn't it? And it was just said, you know, VAR for the first time, and VAR's being put to good use today. That go gave them this energy, didn't it? And they really were in the game, Farah, Manchester United. And Nikita Paris, a player with a point or two to prove. And it looks like that. She's got that attitude today.
Yeah, I think so. And attitude is probably the right word to use for Nikita. She loves playing with that attitude. And when she plays with that, that's when you get the very best out of her. I think this high pressing from Manchester United really suits her. She's an aggressive runner with and without the ball. And you can see her run here. Yes, her and Russo get in each other's way, but she recovers the ball. She's comfortable on the ball and finds a way of getting it into the box.
And you said that she has a point to prove that. She's playing for that. You can see it.
Most definitely. I think when she left Arsenal and joined United, she probably didn't start the best at Man United. I think this is where you see Nikita at her best here. When she gets into the box really, really late from the shot from Ella Toon, and she just works off her. But when she joined Man United, she wasn't playing for Manchester United. She had to work her way into this team. She then got left out of the England team, and that hurt Nikita. I've had Nikita on my podcast this week. The pain that she's playing with to try and get herself back into that squad. With Serena Wiegmann being here at Wembley, showing that she can play and perform on a big occasion, I don't think she's given, you know, herself a bad chance in terms of giving herself putting herself up for selection, come the summer.
She hasn't been in since November, has she? And today she's saying, look, pick me. You've got gaps in this team now. I've got the experience.
It's when she gives the ball away here. You don't want players to give the ball away. It's the aggression to win it back. It's the determination. She doesn't want to lose. Nikita, I've known her since she was a young kid. I used to coach her at Everton. And she's a fighter, and that's a big part of her game. So this game today, how Man United have set up, really suits Nikita.
Let's talk about how they have set up and where they're getting most joy. And it is those wide channels again.
Wide channels. I think the fullbacks for Chelsea need to go out a bit because they're getting exposed. But look, this is what we've seen them do so well in the WSL. It's the movement, not just from one player, Russo. They keep interchanging, and Chelsea players don't know where they're making the runs coming across. But it's been working for them. They are creating the chances. And like you said, they might be going in frustrated knowing that they should have finished one of those. But we can actually see how it's so effective because you've got the likes of Lauren James coming in inside her own half and having to do all the defending and tracking back.
Yeah, I think the fluidity of the Manchester United front four has been phenomenal. Calls this Chelsea back line. Big problems. Chelsea have actually allowed them the wide area most of the half, which, to my surprise, knowing that most of Manchester United's goals come from those wide areas. So really surprising that Chelsea have actually given them that space to play in. They've dealt with them well. Obviously, they've gone in at a half 0-0, so they'll be pleased. But too many chances given up in wide areas from Chelsea.
The big surprise pre-match was that Peniel Harder was left out of the starting lineup, which was an opportunity for Lauren James to really show what she's about. And we've seen some of that, Farah.
We've seen it in glimpses. I think we spoke before the game that what Lauren's got to add to her game, we know she has that raw talent, unbelievable player with a really bright future. When she's not in games, she needs to find a way into games, and she's really struggled with that, Siobhan.
She has, and I think she can come a little bit more in field. You know, when she's running at players 1v1, she's so hard to tackle. If she can get into the box and commit defenders to tackle, it makes it so much more difficult. When she's out here on the touchline, it's not so much of a danger. It's when she's inside the width of the 18-yard box. Can she stay a bit more infield? Can she make defenders commit to making these kind of tackles? inside the 18-yard box, and that's when she's going to cause problems.
Heather, do you know what? I'm going to flip it because I want to give some credit to her ex-teammate, Hannah Blundell. I think she's been strong up against her. She knows what movement she's going to do, and she has had a big half. Both of Manchester United's fullbacks, I think, have been exceptional, and it's going to need to happen again.
That header, Alex, was the first shot on target for Chelsea in that half.
Do you know what, Annette, they would be frustrated with that, but we've seen so many times with Chelsea that they're playing average and then they come up and get a big goal.
I think that's what Chelsea have improved on this season. They played much of the season without the ball and found a way to win games having less possession and less chances in games. So this isn't something new for Chelsea, coming to a cup final and, you know, having less possession, but the save there from Mary Earps has actually kept her team in the game, Siobhan.
I was going to say goalkeepers union over there. Go on, wax lyrical.
I know, at the start I said I wanted to see lots of goals. I said we've seen players here that are on form, that score goals week in, week out. But at the moment, it's the goalkeepers that are doing really well.
At the moment, there has never been a goalless draw in a Women's FA Cup final. Not on our watch. It's not happening today. OK, we've got plenty more football coming up on the BBC. Catch up with all this weekend's Premier League action tonight from 10.30 on BBC One on Match of the Day 2. Listen to live commentary on Wednesday from 8 o'clock on Sounds as Manchester City hosts Real Madrid in the Champions League semi-final second leg. And then we have the small matter of the conclusion of the WSL. If things go Chelsea's way against West Ham on Wednesday, they could be crowned WSL champions on the 21st as they take on Arsenal. You can watch that on BBC One from 12:15. And then join us for the final day. We're hoping it all goes down to that final day of the WSL season on May 27th. Kickoff that day is 2:30. And now, for all you music fans out there, there is this to look forward to.
Radio 1's Big Weekend is coming to Dundee. Lewis Capaldi, Ray, Wet Leg, The 1975, and many more. Let's take you closer to the music. Radio 1's Big Weekend starts Friday 26th of May across the BBC.
Well, there's never been a goalless draw, and we have to go back to 2012 for the last time in an FA Cup final that there was a penalty shootout, and Carly Telford was involved that day for Chelsea, and she right now is with Joe Curry.
Yes, Carly, they've just been talking about some of your experiences in FA Cup finals. You've played in teams, you've played at Wembley, you've played in finals that were played away from Wembley, but when you look at this crowd today, how does this atmosphere differ from what we've seen before?
It's unbelievable, if I'm honest. I had the pleasure of being outside here for a couple of hours and watching it build up. And just to see Wembley Way full of happy families, kids, all different age groups, it's amazing how the game's transformed in the past 12 months. And that's, yeah, all thanks to the Lionesses, but I think it's the consistency, the media, and yeah, it's getting what it's deserved, a sold-out Wembley, it's unbelievable.
You've just been telling me how much you're enjoying retirement life. You call time in your career, though, whilst you were playing in the NWSL in America. How does this atmosphere still compare to what they have out there?
I must admit, I played in a wonderful stadium for a wonderful club. We built a really good team and a really good environment. But when you come back to Wembley, there's something special about being here. Hopefully the fans get a little bit noisier in the second half when we give them something to cheer about. But yeah, it's an unreal atmosphere, and I don't think anything matches Wembley on its day when it's like this.
But I know your nerves are shot to bits in that first half as a Chelsea fan, but enjoy the second half, and it's great to see you back in England.
Thank you so much. Cheers.
Despite no goals, it has really been a great atmosphere here in the first half. And as always in the women's game, it is brilliant to see so many families, so many girls together in a gang, but also, you know, lads out together as well. We saw Joe chatting to some lads, Manchester United fans, ahead of this. It is for everyone, women's football, and today this crowd shows us just that. Let's have a moment, if we can, away from this game to have a little chat about Serena Beekman's here today, about what is going on with her players ahead of this World Cup, because there's been a kind of domino effect of injuries, hasn't there, over the last couple of months or so. If we have a look at the starting 11 for that Germany final last July, and how many players are currently injured, definitely out or retired. It's going to be a very different look, isn't it, to this summer's Lionesses lineup in the World Cup.
It really is. You can concentrate on the negative and how we're missing big, big players with experience, or you can flip it and say, OK, this is a chance for other people to shine and carry the Lionesses and have their moment. Ideally, you always want to be going into a tournament with your strongest team. And I think the Lionesses were actually lucky in the summer, because when you look at every other team, you always have injuries and everything seemed to go their way, but yeah, they're going to need a plan B now.
They certainly are. Who is the hardest to replace from that list?
It's a difficult one. I think your captains, you know, how important Leah Williamson is to this squad, is hugely you know, as in terms of missing. But I think in terms of players that can be replaced, I think they found it really difficult to replace Fran Kirby. I think her creativity in this team is so key. I'm not sure we found a player that delivers in the same way as her. I know the players probably don't see it the same way, but I think when she's not in that team, we really struggle.
I completely agree. I think Fran Kirby is a huge miss for England. I think playing with her, playing against her, you realise how important she is in finding those gaps, finding those key passes and scoring goals when you're up against it. And for me, she's going to be a huge miss for England at the World Cup.
OK, in case you missed it, here's what happened in the first half here.
Another weekend and another historic occasion for women's football. Goal time! 20 seconds on the clock! The flag is up! Keita Paris, straight at Berger. Turner! Berger makes the save. James gets ahead to it. The closest Chelsea have come by far.
Well, the lion's share of the chance in that first half belonged to Mark Skinner's Manchester United. Mary Earps had to be on her game. It's not going to be the same in the second half, though. Chelsea don't play two flat second halves, do they? They will come back.
It will be a much different second half. I'm sure Emma Hayes will be happy that a Chelsea team went in without conceding a goal. So now they have another 45 minutes to really add to their first half performance. I'll expect some changes within the next 20 minutes from this Chelsea team. Potentially harder coming in. They need something more in attack for me.
And a little bit more in terms of Manchester United, it's just getting those chances and making... You're not going to get too many in the second half because they're going to be on you now.
You're going to have to be clinical. You don't want this game to end and you come away with regrets and saying the what-ifs and looking back on this game. But Emma Hayes knows. She's been here before. They are serial winners and she's going to expect a better performance this half.
Somebody's got to break through this Chelsea stranglehold. Is it going to be Manchester United, Siobhan?
I'm back in Alessia Russo. She's had a quiet-ish first half in front of goal, but you give her a sniff in front of goal. Normally, she's clinical, she's ruthless, and that's why she's done so well for both United and for England.
OK, let's head up to our commentary team then. Rachel Brown-Finnis and Robin Cowan are ready for you.
Yes, thank you very much, Gabby. So the two teams back out, and as mentioned at half-time there, Rachel, Manchester United will have to be prepared. Be very unlikely that Chelsea put in such a flat performance as they did in that first half, and as we can see in our picture here, they have one of the best forwards in the world to bring off the bench if needed. That level of performance that they put out there, Manchester United in the first half, must be maintained.
Yeah, I think Fionnuala Harder will come on sooner rather than later. See her around the 60-minute mark. Came on, like you said, last couple of games, scored a couple of goals, albeit against teams they should be pumping goals past. Manchester United are a different prospect, but they need something different. They've not even, other than long balls high up to Sam Kerr and a little bit of trickery down this right-hand side from Lauren James, they've had no free-flowing attacks. Jesse Fleming's not got involved as much. Sam Kerr's not had those little balls threaded through to her. They've been really flat in regards to attacking. So Fionnuala Harder will change all of that and she'll cause a completely different problem for the back line of Manchester United too.
Well, Sam Kerr says she never leaves Wembley without a trophy. And you'd be a fool to bet against her, but they haven't really found her so far. But how many times has she had a quiet game in inverted commas and then ended up being the match winner? Manchester United get us underway. Ball over to the far side and Leah Galton.
She walks the walk, Sam Kerr, doesn't she?
It's very interesting to hear how superstitious she is in the interview that Alex Scott did with her in the build-up. And also the
bolognese butty.
Pre-match meal, which sounds rather heavy.
It's what works, Robin.
Well, if I could play like her, maybe we'll give it a go.
Yeah, hopefully we'll get to the bottom of exactly what is in that. Pasta sandwich doesn't sound... Sounds very beige, doesn't it? It's the same, you know, big games, you try and stick to your routine as much as you can. Try and eat at the same times. Look at the 2:30 kickoff. When are you going to be warming up? 1 o'clock-ish, a bit later. Okay, so you work backwards from those key timings of the day, and you know that sticking to the same routine takes away any changes. Change is always unsettling. And coming into a big game like this, that's what you want to try and reduce.
Here's Mara Bielder. Ben Ladd, good positioning. It's been a feature of Manchester United's midfield this game so far. Two. Galton tried the first time ball onto Alessia Russo. Galton putting Mielder under pressure. They work it back to Berger.
So Galton and Toonen, exactly the same start. Ensuring that the midfield, Cuthbert and Leopold, no time on the ball at all to start attacks.
Galton. James gets back and makes the challenge. Wrighton. Too much on that for Neve Charles. Back in Manchester United possession. One defeat in their last 20 games in all competitions, Manchester United, and that was to Chelsea.
Nine encounters, eight losses and only one draw. Head-to-head, Manchester United against Chelsea. The breakthrough this season in beating Arsenal.
Kerr, Fleming. To slip it through for James. Well read by Turner.
So that was one of the things. Serena Wiegmann looking proudly down. Many of her lionesses today, fond memories of the summer. Doing snow angels in the confetti on the pitch after the match. You were, Robin?
Happy memories, and she's got a big old task at the World Cup, given the absences in the England squad that were outlined at the half-time break.
Seeing Millie Brighton Crutches attending today's game. She is key at the heart of that defence for England. Serena Wiegmann desperately hoping that she'll be back and available and ready to go.
Well held up by Russo to Letizia.
Letizia be one of those that Serena Wiegmann's looking at. Performance, you know, on a huge stage. That's something that Serena Wiegmann will be looking to see how some of these younger players will be dealing with the occasion.
Eriksen sends it forward. Wrighton with the first time cross. It's an awkward clearance from Letizia. Kerr onto it straight away. Galton didn't have too many options. Mielder's lost it. It's Russo! Berger in the right place.
That's where he bowled it out early as a goalkeeper start the attack, and in two passes. Throw out there, then the ball down to Russo, muscles off Erin Cuthbert, just lets the ball bounce past her, boshes her off, gives herself a yard of space.
Charles up against Badger, two very pacey fullbacks. Ladd gets a foot in. Walton makes good ground, picks out two. Walton continues her run. Nikita Paris is all alone at the far post. Galton back to Blundell. Two. Galton. Chelsea now back in a decent looking shape. And ball from Ladd straight to Berger.
Yeah, you take too many touches, too many phases, and that's what happens. 9-10 players of Chelsea all bunched up in a very small space, and it's hard to get your shot off or to slip any balls through. There was space down that left-hand side. Ella Toon had doubled up on Perisic. Just wasn't playing quick enough by United.
Another good win from Kurt. Wrighton. Again, the early ball, defended by Turner. Trying to feed Kerr a little earlier. Chelsea, in contrast to Manchester United, not taking too many touches when they get in those positions. Leupolz. And now James. Kerr. Around the corner, but it's Ladd who gives it away this time to Fleming. James. Turner with the header away. Leupolz rides the challenge. Knocks over Katie Zellum, who's got to her feet and makes the challenge. Advantage played. Here's Badger. Now Russo. Toon looks offside, but the flag has stayed down for now. Toon to the byline. It's still Ella Toon. Can't find Russo. And now the flag is up.
It's clearly offside. It's right in front of the line, the assistant. It's such an energy-sapping afternoon. The tempo that both teams have played at, taking out those few hundred extra metres of running would be preferable as a former player. A couple of tasty tackles prior to that. One Gura Ryan on Katie Zellum just before, and that's why she's been awarded a yellow card.
She is a committed, wholehearted individual, Gura Wrighton.
Katie Zellum.
Bolton. Another shot on target, but another easy take for the goalkeeper who got into a good position once again.
She preferred it on a right, on a left foot, wouldn't she, Leah Galton? But really good thinking by May Letizia. Great run from Leah Galton. Can't touch it down first time, and it's a little snapshot. This is the tackle Gura Ryan got booked for. No ball. Yellow card.
It's a dangerous ball over the top for James. Millie Turner does enough.
Yeah, really good covering on it because Anna Blundell stepped out of position. Across Millie Turner.
Free kick for Chelsea, which they take quickly. Here's Wrighton, trying to up the tempo now. As Manchester United player seems to be relishing the challenge up against Lauren James, who left them two summers ago.
She came and played a lot of first team football at Manchester United, and as the stock had risen, went to Chelsea.
Badger steps in, another advantage played. Neve Charles clatters her. Toon finds the kick. Badger still down here, but Paris in a lot of space. Time to measure the cross. Perisic concedes the corner. And a yellow card is also given to Neve Charles.
That's a brilliant ball from Nikita Paris. Sees Alessia Russo drifting in at the back post. Needs to get it over and beyond Berger, and it just drifts too far. Really well picked up by Perisic, and this is where you get the yellow card. Yeah, ball's going past me, but the player is not. Neve Charles. It's a yellow card. spiced up, hasn't it, in this last sort of 5-10 minutes.
That's both players down that Chelsea left who've been booked, so it wouldn't be too surprising to see changes. And it looks like Chelsea are going to make a couple, but first of all they're going to have to defend this corner kick. It's deep towards Turner, kept alive. Paris can't keep it in.
Turner looks so threatening, doesn't she? Set pieces, she's always the target for them. Marshalled really well by Neve Charles. Just does enough so she's not got a free header. What a tussly match at the back post, gets up really well.
And Pernilla Harder coming on. Sophie Ingle also coming onto the field. Melody Lerpols and Jessie Fleming, the players to make way.
Yeah, to be expected. Jess Fleming's not really got into the game, not been able to have so much of an attacking impact. And put Nilla Harder in now, and she's a completely different prospect. Not masses of difference in quality, just a different outfit. Nilla Harder, lots of athleticism. Focal figure as well for set pieces.
Tissier didn't quit quite enough on that. And United could be in trouble here. It's Harder! Put off just enough. Oh, what an introduction that would have been.
What a ball this is. Great ball to Sam Kerr, but this ball here from Sam Kerr, she picks it up, lovely touch inside onto her preferred right foot. That's exactly the right weight on it to thread it between the two players of Manchester United. She only had Pernilla Harder for support. It just gets, a touch gets stuck under her feet a bit, Pernilla Harder. Can't quite angle her body and keep her balance to get the firepower to beat Mary Earps. Mary Earps stands up well, gets her positioning right, makes a simple save in the end. Straight away, just shows you the threat that Pernilla Harder has. Play more of a two up top, don't they, with Sam Kerr, Pernilla Harder, rather than strictly beaten in that attacking midfield position.
Different proposition for the Manchester United back line. Rachel Williams ready to come on for Manchester United. Usually that comes a little bit later, but it'll be interesting to see who she comes on for. Scored the late winner against Brighton in the semi-final.
Rachel Williams, England international.
Turner in a clash with Harder. Our referee is continue to play on here. She's going to have to stop this now for a potential head injury. Cheeky off the ball there from Millie Turner.
Just in the replay now, I hadn't seen anything in it initially, but as Millie Turner played the ball, she just stands her ground. Millie Turner, she does know what she's doing. And Pernilla Harder runs into it. Don't think that's outside of the laws of the game.
Well, the change for Manchester United on the hour. Rachel Williams on for Nikita Paris.
I'm just trying to see if there's a tactical change. whether Katie Zellum's going to come higher up, and yeah, Ella Toon maybe coming out on this right hand side. Rachel Williams play more of a 10 role and join in with Alessia Russo.
The referee has dropped her pen. Return to her by Katie Zellum. Surprised by that change?
I think it's a tactical change. See Alessia Russo come out, Ella Toon come out to the right hand side. So if it had been like for like, yeah, absolutely. I would have been surprised with that, but I can see what it is. You know, that front line has worked so hard, covering lots of spaces. Rachel Williams is such a strong powerhouse to hold it up and run in beyond.
Mixed fortunes for Rachel Williams against Chelsea, a runner-up in 2015 with Notts County, but a winner with Birmingham in 2012. She's been around for an awful long time, 35 years old, but says she's not going to retire. She's going to go back to her old job as a plasterer. This is like a hobby for her. Something she's managed to make into a job for now, it seems.
Well, that era of football, including myself, it was a hobby that, you know, turned in the very latter years to a profession. It was a hobby we took very, very seriously and worked at every single day, but we certainly didn't pay the bills. So the likes of Rachel Williams had her own cement, a plastering business. One of many professions in that Team GB 2012 squad we were all in.
Toon picking up some good positions in the first half. Haven't seen as much of her in the second. We'll see what this switch can do for Manchester United.
Yeah, Nikita Paris was very, very effective. She's not been brought off for her performance. I believe it's a tactical change to bring on Rachel Williams and support Alessia Russo in that central role.
Here's Wrighton. Delivers the ball in, away by Blundell. Cuthbert clattered. That is going to be a free kick for Chelsea.
Yeah, it's just late, wasn't it? Went up for the ball, didn't get anything. Charged into Cuthbert. Seen her do that before, I recall.
Getting stuck in straight away, but that's been the tone that's been set by her teammates.
Do you know, United have done this all season as well, Manchester United, and that's why they are currently top of the table in the Women's Super League, and they are here in the final because they're called United, but they have been united as a team, done everything together.
Sent forward by Wrighton towards the back post. Kerr wins it. Away by Ladd.
Been the busier of the two goalkeepers in the first half mainly.
Earps goes long towards Russo, well won by Mielder. Cuthbert trying to wriggle away from Ladd. Finds James, great ball from Lauren James. It's Pernilla Harder. Can't pick out Kerr. Cuthbert on the stretch. Can't find the target.
Well, she's had an instant impact, hasn't she? Since she came on just over 5 minutes ago, she's had two chances, two shots on goal. Pernilla Harder just strays offside. No initial flag. Look at that. Just breaches the back line. The way she stretches the back line, gets on the back shoulder, it's just so difficult to mark. Lovely little touch from Mary Earps. And the defence come back nice and narrow. Able to get rid of it. They've looked a different outfit since Pernilla Harder has been on the pitch.
They've missed her, but they've absorbed her absence fairly well, especially in the league, still in their hands. Ingle down now, Wales captain.
She got felled from a lofty height. See there, if it makes it get taken away, can't land, just... I think it's other than anything other than being winded, landed on your back. Such a long time, she's reaped a lot of the rewards of the progression of this Chelsea squad under the expert leadership of Emma Hayes.
Wrighton, here's Harder, and Kerr! Inevitable! The hour cometh the sun. The third FA Cup final she scored in a row. You could never count Kerr out.
Goal scorer for Chelsea, number 20, Sarah
Chelsea ahead.
And Pernilla Harder put it on a plate, didn't she? And it's so preventable. Throw in there, missed by Hayley Ladd, and that's where it opens up. Guru Wrighton slides it through. Everybody's out of position. Pernilla Harder looks up, knows exactly where Sam Kerr is going to be. Central off the back shoulder of Maya Letizier, and she doesn't break stride in. Mary Earps can't get across in time to cover that back post. Precision, world-class play from Pernilla Harder, and finished by Sam Kerr. Delight for Emma Hayes. Absolute beautiful weighting of the pass beyond May Letizier. Look at this for a celebration.
She only pulls this out on the big occasion. And she stuck the landing as well.
It's a 10 from me.
Still time for Manchester United to get back into this, but just saw this coming. This is what Chelsea do. And I think this was the big hurdle that Manchester United needed to overcome. Chelsea don't have to play well in order to win. Manchester United pretty much have to be perfect, and they nearly have been.
I wouldn't write Manchester United off because they have created chances. But Pernilla Harder has been the one to finally open up Manchester United. Right, that's the one last hurdle Manchester United have not managed to get over since their existence. And that is beating Chelsea.
Well, let's not write them off just yet. 20 minutes still to go, and this will be the big test. They have the quality. Do they have the mentality to get back into this? Chelsea have shown they've been vulnerable. They didn't take the big chances when they came in the first half. Becomes just the second player to score in three consecutive cup finals after Kim Little for Arsenal. But Jess Carter getting ready to come on for Chelsea. Fairly surprising omission. She's been starting regularly.
Aaron Mielder back fit. chosen ahead of Jess Carter.
Oh, that's sloppy from Zellum. Harder. Now Wrighton. United win it back. Toon. Chelsea trying to apply the high press. They'll allow Mary Earps to decide how she's going to get rid of this one.
Since that tactical change and Ella Toon coming out onto the right, in possession, Manchester United do not look as incisive.
Neve Charles coming off, and the beaming smile on Jess Carter's face. Scored in the quarter-final against Reading. And might just play a bigger part for England in the summer due to the injuries in the back line.
Going to come in. Neve Charles getting applauded off the pitch behind Mary Epps's goal is the allocation of Chelsea fans. What a feeling that is.
Tissier forward towards Russo. Here's James. Jockeyed well by Hannah Blundell, but Chelsea still in possession. Fired in towards the box, and Sam Kerr can't quite get on the end of it.
It just drifted far beyond it, didn't it? But again, United are just off the pace a little bit. The press in midfield is not quite there since the change. And those gaps opening up are giving Chelsea a bit more time to be able to play their game.
It's a record attendance, as we expected, 77,390. It's a world record for a women's domestic game. Beating the previous one, Atletico Madrid against Barcelona, which was just over 60,000, it's been smashed today.
I came to Wembley as an eight-year-old girl for the first ever time watching a match, and that was my spark moment, my moment where football became everything to me, and it was wonderful going on Olympic Way, Wembley Way earlier today and seeing so many young people hopefully being able to have that same experience. What a journey I've been on ever since.
Cuthbert might get another bite of the cherry here. Too physical from Cuthbert. Williams did well to stand her ground.
Cheeky that from Erin Cuthbert. Shouts at the referee, we were stuck. You see here as they're getting a little tussle. Mitch Williams doing really well holding, encouraging the contact, going down. He got tangled, but could this be a chance for Manchester United? And Katie Zellum, no doubt, taking it to get back in the tie.
Even those dead ball deliveries that are usually so pinpoint from Zellum have dried up. The tactical change hasn't worked, Rachel, but also heads have dropped a little bit, would you say?
Well, I think with Pernilla Harder coming on to such great effect and at a very similar time, Mark Skinner changing Manchester United's tactical lineup to very much a lesser effect. I was astounded really when Nikita Paris came off because I thought she was one of the most dangerous players for Manchester United, and it did seem to be working so well. And it looks like he's ready to make more changes, Mark Skinner.
Here's Carter.
Yeah, for me, you've got to get Ella Toon back in that central role.
A couple of towering headers from Williams, but picked up by Perisse. James with the chop. Lad stops her, but only for a little bit. Still going, Lauren James. Digs the cross out. Confident play, as we expect. Galton. Closed down by Cuthbert. Decision has gone Chelsea's way. Russo cutting an isolated figure now. And a double change. Imminent for Manchester United.
At this point, Manchester United would be absolutely desperate to get back in the game, take anything to take it to extra time.
Badger with the loose touch. Here's Harder, needing a bit of support. Lucia Garcia on. See her game time limited a little bit. Ella Toon withdrawn.
And
Hannah Blundell also off for Aoife Mannion.
Williams will play that role that Ella Toon played, attacking midfielder.
Unfamiliar feeling for Ella Toon at this stadium. She has been a winner here twice with England, and she has scored here twice with England. For her club, though, been a frustrating afternoon. Harder with the boundless energy, but...
In the first half, first hour, arguably, Toon and Harris were the most effective players for Manchester United, were causing the most problems for Chelsea. Starting to tire, possibly. Maybe it was a pre-rehearsed tactical change.
James kicking the ball away. He's got a yellow card. Cleared upfield by Jess Carter. It's turned into a brilliant ball from the back. Here's Kerr. Scoops it past Letizia. Well, that should have been two. Sophie Ingle coming onto it, couldn't keep it down.
Yeah, Great work from Sam Kerr. Squares it across, and what a chance that is for Sophie Ingle. That would have sealed the deal for Chelsea. Such professionals. Know how to ride a game out, know how to finish a game.
Again, still time. Just under 9 minutes of normal time.
Rachel Williams is a loves a late goal for a team.
Bolton on the chase. We'll keep it in. Options in the middle. Close down. James onto Cuthbert.
Chelsea are just going to want to keep possession, run the energy out of Manchester United's legs, because they're going to have, knowing that they're chasing the game, chasing something, wanting to leave everything on the pitch. Doesn't have to look pretty, but you come out on the winning side. Emma Hayes knows and has been there and done it before. That is the most important thing.
A lot of movement ahead for Letizia. Williams offering herself up. They need some inspiration from somewhere, Manchester United.
And the front line are urging Mary Earps to go along to them. I feel they've got the beating of the back line of Chelsea.
Zellum into the channel. No chances taken by Carter.
Good territory gained from Manchester United point of view, but good defending from Jess Carter. Gets across, no messing.
Russo. So often the instigator of the attacks for Manchester United. Kept in by Badger. Away from Carter. This could be a chance. Russo scuffs it. Williams couldn't get a connection either.
Oh, that was the chance. Brilliant, and Dan Fromo on a Badger there. Skips past Jess Carter, does so well. Dying minutes of the game, and it's Alessia Russo. He scoffs that initial chance. And then Rach Williams just has to have a stab at it. Good defending from Eve Perisse to make that a more difficult chance for Rachel Williams. And I think it's Eve Perisse who's down. Rachel Williams stood on her foot. Nasty one. But completely accidental. And this gives Mark Skinner a chance to get his collective together and have one last word, one last gathering, one last motivational bit of information.
One last push for Manchester United. With a familiar face on the score sheet.
Beautiful, wasn't it? It really was. A beautifully weighted ball through from Guru Wrighton. Just found the gaps. Guru Wrighton in a positioning rolled Hayley Ladd, threaded it through for Pinella Harder. One, two, three, four steps. Put it on a plate for Sam Kerr, who didn't have to break her stride. And the big player shows up in the big games. And that is exactly what Sam Kerr is.
Goal number 10 in her seventh cup final for Chelsea. Ever present. Seemed like the script had already been written.
Well, she said she never goes home without a medal. I'm guessing she meant gold.
Is there going to be a run of pasta sandwiches, bolognese baguettes, carbonara ciabattas?
Fusili for catches.
Sam Sourdough's. Am I in the right ballpark there?
We'll market that at Chelsea. Had Emma Hayes hot dogs, didn't we?
Oh my goodness.
4 minutes for Manchester United to raise the roof and perhaps force extra time. This is their first ever FA Cup final. They've only been... Well, they've only had a women's football team for the last 5 years. Mark Skinner was saying they are possibly ahead of schedule, but they are an ambitious club, one that has been backed well. Yellow card out.
Substitution for Chelsea. Leaving the field, number 10, Lauren James.
Another change for Chelsea. Khadisha Buchanan, defender on for Lauren James. Try and see this one out.
Yeah, they've got five at the back. Three centrally. Khadisha Buchanan, one of those three central players. And Lauren James just turns to the Manchester United fans.
Being replaced by number 26, Khadisha Buchanan.
There's a yellow card for Ingle for that challenge. So Buchanan, who's also been out for some time with a knee injury. Here's Zellum. You're allowed to take that down. As Manchester United push forward, Chelsea could try and pounce, but that's careless from Pernille Harder, straight back to Mary Earps.
It's one of those where you're sure you've seen Sam Kerr making a run and then, oh, she wasn't there. I'll tell you what, this Chelsea team has been transformed since Pernille Harder's come on the pitch.
2 minutes remaining and Rachel Brown for initial Vitality FA Cup player of the match.
Transformed by Pernille Harder, but executed and finished off by this one, Sam Kerr. Game changer, one of the world's best. And today my player of the match.
First player to be crowned Football Writers Player of the Year for a second consecutive season. What would they do without Sam Kerr and her team?
Well, she's that spark, isn't she, that a team, even though they've not played at their best today, Emma Hayes, I'm sure will admit that, they've ground out, and when they've needed that flash of quality just to seal the deal, then it was there.
Final minutes of normal time. Chelsea, since scoring, kept Manchester United at arm's length. The half chance, actually more than a half chance, I'd say, for Russo. Good work from Badger.
It's the, you know, tired legs, 87 minutes of running at that point. You're not at your sharpest to be able to finish that one chance that you need. And that's what we saw with Russo. But going back to the schedule of Manchester United, they have. It's remarkable what they've done in 5 years of existence.
Flicked on towards goal, Williams. It was always going to be a difficult chance to really trouble Berger.
There will be a minimum of 6 minutes of additional time.
And that could be music to the ears of Manchester United. 6 minutes. And they use it wisely.
Roll of the dice. Mark Skinner.
Arthur Thomas.
Another
forward on for midfielder Hayley Ladd.
Being replaced by number 9, Martha Thomas.
Well, they've got to go for it. Chelsea have got to stand firm.
It's been a game of excellent skill, of
pressure from Thomas, straight from the off.
Excellent skill, high quality.
Aoife Mannion tasked with the throw-in situation, finds Alessia Russo.
An excellent game management as well from Chelsea.
Did just creep out of play.
I think it just reeks really of a team that has been here and done it before. And a team really who's here for the very first time. The way that Chelsea have not panicked, maybe. Manchester United ran themselves into the ground a little too early.
Into the final 4 minutes. Letizia on the diagonal. Garcia keeps it in. Retrieved by Badger. Zellum. Nodded wide. Plenty in the middle there. Not the right connection. And I think the offside flag's gone up as well.
You see what Chelsea do. Emma Hayes brought on an extra defender, and that's the one who contested the header with Alessia Russo. Made it difficult.
Chelsea's number 20, Sam Kerr.
It's almost become muscle memory for Chelsea, hasn't it? Winning these trophies, everything that is thrown at them. They seem to be able to navigate.
That's it, they've gone from back-to-back, you know, convincing WSL wins where they've free-flowed and scored lots of goals to a really tough test where there's very, very little in it. But they know how to win both ways, with flamboyance and open play and skill. But this has been grit, determination, and then just as Man United switched off, Hayley Ladd was rolled by Guru Wrighton and the chance opened up. Wrighton rolled the ball through to Pernille Harder, and it was simple. Sam Kerr was free in the middle. They were just confident that chance would come.
Flag has stayed down. Again, another late one. Particularly frustrating for Manchester United. 2 minutes. Need to throw everything forward here, Manchester United. Zellum. Away from Cuthbert. Brilliant play from Cuthbert.
I feel like Aaron Cuthbert's been around forever and she's barely been spoken of today, but does such an integral job to that heart of midfield for Chelsea.
Mannion's won it back from Harder. Skips away from the challenge of Ingle. That's good play. Bolton. Away from Khadisha Buchanan. Puts it out of play for a corner. Is this it? Is this the final chance? Less than a minute to play. Mary Earps is up.
She couldn't. Well, those Manchester United fans behind the goal will be trying to suck the ball into the net.
They've scored a fair few late goals this season. Can they do it here on the biggest stage of all? Kept alive. And cleared. Throw to Manchester United. Turner flings it in. Ingle gets her head to it. Back in by Garcia. Garcia with the cross. Pulled away. Berger nearly lost it. Agonising.
Oh, he nearly dropped a Leah Golden, I think it was, right on the edge of the six-yard box. It's Leah Golden's whose strike it is. Just recycled back out. Lucia Garcia does really well. Martha Thomas, the header, touchdown in lots of space. Picks out a nice area, not dealt with. Oh, and it drops to Leah Golden, who has run her legs off today for Manchester United. It hits her own player, I think, Rachel Williams. And here you see, oh, just, she should be punching that and catching Berger, but somehow Chelsea get bodies behind the ball on the line, covering that. She gets away with one there, does Berger. And that seems like it's the last chance for Manchester United.
Narrow margins favour Chelsea. The colour.
What a fight by Manchester United, but ultimately that little bit of quality and poise that was needed came from this one, from Sam Kerr. What a big game player. Wembley blue success. All equates to Emma Hayes and Sam Kerr.
Chelsea champions again of the
Wembley. I'm delighted to say that
FA Cup
now is Chelsea's Eric Cuthbert. Eric, congratulations.
A brave fight by Manchester United in the end. A familiar winner and a familiar goal scorer. Full time at Wembley. Chelsea 1, Manchester United 0.
Wow, what a dramatic ending to a cracking cup final. 1-0 doesn't tell the story, does it, of what we've just seen there, Alex Scott?
It really doesn't. The song, blue is the colour, winning is their name, they do it once again. They are serial winners and they know how to get the job done. Some big performances in the second half from Chelsea, but for me, it was all about the subs from both sides. Emma Hayes, tactical awareness to bring on Pernilla Harder, totally changed the game. And I think for me, taking off Nikita Paris, Mark Skinner, I think was a wrong decision because it was hard for them. But just look at the scenes and the celebrations and taking it all in from Chelsea players once again.
Congratulations. Chelsea have got a stranglehold, haven't they, at the FA Cup at the moment. The belief to come back in the second half the way they did, they have nothing to offer really in the first half. It was all Manchester United in terms of the chances, but as we knew they would, they stepped it up and they've got players like Pernille Harder who can come on and make such a difference.
Exactly that, and we heard Emma Hayes say before the game the impact she knew that Harder would have come that 60-minute moment, and I think that was a game-changing moment for this Chelsea team. The impact Harder had from coming on the pitch, it was instant. She had a chance within a minute of getting herself on the pitch, and then obviously she was the reason why Sam Kerr was able to probably tap away her easiest FA Cup final goal ever and put Chelsea 1-0 ahead and eventually win them the game.
Well, she is. She's a serial scorer, 8-8 now, and a serial winner, Sam Kerr. Incredible. She's the fifth player ever to score in three successive FA Cup finals. Siobhan, that clinical finishing is what Manchester United could have done within the first half. They had their chances.
It definitely could have. And when you play a team like Chelsea, you need to be clinical, you need to be ruthless, because they're not going to give you a lot of chances. So when you've got them, you need to take them. And unfortunately for Manchester United, they didn't do that in that first half. And the second half, Chelsea weren't at their best, but they showed their class. They showed their ability to be ruthless in front of goal, to be clinical, what Manchester United didn't show in the first half, and ultimately got the victory today.
It's a psychological blow to them, Manchester United, to come to their first final and to not come away with the victory, the trophy, and then they look at the league as well, where they've led for so many moments this season. It's flip-flopped eight times, hasn't it, between the two. Chelsea's experience is something, you know, you can't just get experience. It comes with time, and this will be a huge learning curve for Manchester United.
They're huge. They can't take a backward step from this. It's all about taking, learning things from today, and you can't now let this affect them going in to the end of the season. It's hard, it's going to hurt, but they have to pick themselves up and carry on for the rest of the season. And can they do it again next season and get to this same venue?
I think we heard Mark Skinner say before, the games, it's moments like this, it's big games, big occasions where you learn from it. These Manchester United players would have learned an awful lot from this game today against Chelsea. They were the better team over the 90 minutes. They just didn't take their chances. Chelsea showed that experience. They showed that clinicalness that was needed inside the box. And Sam Kerr gets them the goal. Them big moments are what count. Those Man United players would learn a lot from this game today, for sure.
Mark Skinner has huge ambitions for this side, and he said losing here today would not be seen as a success for him. You know, it's only winning that he's ultimately going to be judged by, and trophies. But you do take small steps towards those greater goals, those greater mountains.
You do. It won't be any consolation for them today. They'll be really unhappy with the result, how it's happened. But you have got to take those small positives. And the fact that they've got to the final, they're at the top of the league at the moment.
You can see what it means to the players. Alicia Russo there with tears in her eyes. Absolutely devastated. Because those players have come to be winners on the big stage of England, haven't they? And they come to Wembley, a place they call home when they're wearing the shirt of England, Alex. And today there will be enormous disappointment in the talent in that Manchester United squad.
You need to take that feeling of pain and the hunger to want more. But this Chelsea side, it's actually Emma Hayes was the one that said, this place feels like home to Chelsea. They've played more times here than they have at Stamford Bridge. They are used to this.
That in itself is incredible, isn't it? This stage for Chelsea currently over the last few years, it feels like home. It's not far from home, Farah, is it? And the blue end of Wembley is thrilled with what they've just seen, because their women really had to suck up a lot of pressure in that first half. But as they've done, and the pattern of their season so many times, WSL, is to soak up that pressure and come again. And they relied on their clinical finisher, Sam Kerr, who's with Joe Curry.
Well, Sam, we've just been enjoying some of your dance moves. Congratulations. That must have been pretty special in the end.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's a sign of a great team. We honestly didn't have our best game today, but that's a sign of a great team when you just push through, and everyone did their part today and we stuck in it, and yeah, we got the win in the end.
Another FA Cup, another goal in the final from yourself. What is it with you and this love affair with the FA Cup competition?
I don't know. I mean, he did amazing, the team did amazing. I'd be lying if I said it was all me. They do amazing, and I'm just blessed to be the nine in this team. It's an amazing team.
You were the team that were the clinical in the end. You've done it on the biggest stage in front of a record crowd. The crowd loved your backflip today. Do you know before the game, if you score, you're going to whip that one out?
You know what? A lot of people have been asking me for it, and Millie asked me for it. I texted my friend and I said backflip incoming, so I knew it was coming today.
Look, I know you've got an important league game midweek, so I'm not sure if Emma Hayes is going to let you drink this or celebrate too much, but you are the player of the match, the vitality player of the match. Congratulations.
Look, I don't deserve this. People are way more better than me today, but I will take it on behalf of the team. Thank you.
Penina, another final, another cup title. Where does that one rank for you?
Well, yeah, as much as the other ones. It's amazing to win titles. So, yeah, it was amazing, and this, like, a full Wembley is amazing.
And because you've been out for a lot of this season with injury, did that one feel that little bit more special? Because you've come back just in time to be involved, to set up the goal. It was magnificent.
Yeah, of course. It's sad when you're out for so long, but then when you come back, you just have so much energy, motivation, hunger. So, yeah, it's amazing to come back to this game and now to be involved in the win.
What does this club mean to you?
The club.
What does Chelsea mean to you? We know your contract's up at the end of the season.
Oh, Chelsea means a lot to me. Listen, I've had so many good memories here. The fans are unbelievable.
Well, look, enjoy tonight, enjoy the celebrations, and good luck for the rest of the season.
Thank you.
Penina Harder has been part of such a successful period in Chelsea's history. They're halfway towards another double. It will be their third successive double under Emma Hayes. They have won so many trophies, they've won so many records, and they've been at the part of the game, obviously, in terms of its history, where we're seeing this, a full Wembley, and Peniel Harder really came on today and made a massive difference, didn't she?
And that's where Emma shows her class once again, knowing that she's had so many games, three games since she's come back from the injury, I know she's going to be able to come on and make a huge impact, and that's what she did. Her movement, her work rate, the ability to link James with her, and this pass, the pass appreciation is absolutely everything. Putting it on a plate for your teammate to end and finish it and go on to win. It was her that actually made a huge difference to go on and win this game for them, Farah.
She most definitely was the difference. I think Manchester United's back four were too comfortable for too long. What Harder did when she come on was run beyond that back four, made that back four face their own goal. Any defender, Alex, you know this, don't like to face your goal, and she did that constantly. The 30 minutes she was on the pitch, she ran beyond. Sam Kerr's six flick-ons, it was Harder running beyond. And then that most important run that she did that then sets up her teammate Kerr for the winning goal was phenomenal. The pass was perfect.
You can't even do that on a trampoline fast.
No, I can't do the celebration on a trampoline. What an unbelievable celebration.
Have a pasta sandwich for lunch, Farah, then you're not going to achieve it, are you?
I know.
Maybe I'll do that and get on the trampoline.
But you know what?
A pre-match meal.
Just behind us, Emma Hayes is waiting to walk the stairs there. And she was saying, look, she was exhausted how much that game took it out of her. But their ability to go and win once again.
It was the end of the game in particular, which we were just sat behind her there. And, you know, the tension when Manchester United had chance after chance there at the end to get themselves back into this game and force this game into extra time, Siobhan. You know, you could see both camps, you know, Mark Skinner as well, just absolutely on the edge of their nerves.
They are, and I think Alex said it before about giving credit to Emma Hayes and their consistency. The squad of players that she's got, to manage to keep them happy, they don't play week in, week out, but you've got to keep all of those players happy because you need a squad of players to be able to achieve what she's done. And that's huge credit to Emma Hayes, and to know how to utilise them and to keep them at the top of their game for when they are needed.
Well, a player like Peniel Harder, for example, you know, with the class that she brings and the unbelievable talent, and for Norway as well as Chelsea, of course, Farah, to tell her you're on the bench for an FA Cup final.
It's difficult when you're a big player used to starting games, and as you mentioned there, for your national team for Denmark being so impactful, when you come to domestic football you expect to play, so it's a really difficult conversation. But I think Emma Hayes has that relationship with her players, that mutual respect where players understand decisions, and I think winning helps you accept those decision makings.
Well, the occasion today has been so special. A sellout crowd. In the end, 77,000 was the official number given. A record, of course, in the women's game. And, well, you can imagine some of the Reds have decided it's time to head up north and head home. Transport's not been easy around the country this weekend, has it? They're not going to stay necessarily to see Chelsea lift their trophy, but the Blue End definitely are. At the moment, it's the Manchester United players who are heading up to get their losers' medals. That's always a tough moment, isn't it? Because the hope, the expectation that you're going to crack this team who've held so much dominance would have been there. And the form they've shown this season, but that record goes on. 10 times they've played against Chelsea, Manchester United, and yet to come away with a win.
It does, and walking up those steps to collect those runners-up medals will be difficult for them. They'll be emotional, but that's what they've got to take from this. They've got to remember this feeling and know that next season they want to go one step better. You don't always win everything the first time of asking. It's about coming back better next year, using this feeling to motivate yourself to be in this final next year and to be the ones lifting that trophy.
This is painful. Farah, do you remember Euros 2009? I will never forget that feeling, walking past the trophy, knowing that you were so close. But you have to use it as motivation.
I'm just glad the only time I played at Wembley in an FA Cup final, I won. I lost FA Cups 4 years on the bounce. And I would have hated that feeling of walking the Wembley stairs to walk past the trophy. So I can't imagine how it feels for these girls.
Do you know what? You're exhausted.
I'm glad you won as well, Farah, because I know what you're like when you're angry. So I'm glad
true.
You won here.
This is true.
His Royal Highness, the Prince of Wales, Prince William there, who's handing out those medals. And in a moment, he'll be doing the rather more joyful job of handing over the FA Cup trophy to Chelsea and that is the third time in a row for them. They have been phenomenally successful in this competition in recent years. They are going for another title in the WSL as well. Emma Hayes, regularly nominated for Coach of the Year, and of course a team full of superstars, not least Sam Kerr, who will be one of the stars in a home World Cup this summer. She was rested during the week. She had a little knock, rested against Leicester, but she's come up today and scored that vital goal. But Manchester United and Katie Zellum, their captain, will take so much from this experience. They are breaking into that stranglehold at the top of the women's game that's so far been dominated by Manchester City, Arsenal, and of course Chelsea. But it is time though to hand you over to our commentary team for the presentation of the trophy and the medals to those winners in blue. Let's hand you back to Robin Cowan.
Yes, thank you much, Gabby. Emma Hayes gets ready to lead her Chelsea team up the steps to the Royal Box to receive yet more winners medals and of course the FA Cup trophy, their fifth. And so it's been 9 years. Here come the winners of medals, Corporal Rachel House from the RAF. She is an RAF survival equipment technician based at RAF Coningsby and has served for just over a decade so far. She's vice captain of the RAF women's representative football team and she also plays for Lincoln City Women. Well, they're going to savour this. Something they've done before for some. It is their fourth time. But they've done it against Manchester United, who are currently top of the WSL, who gave them an awkward game. And they've also done it in front of a record crowd of over 77,000, and the majority inside Wembley who have remained are wearing blue. And Rachel Brown-Finnis, now the double in their sights.
And who would bet against them with their gritty performance like that? Said they've played some wonderful, sensational, flowing football this season. They've also ground out results, found a way to win, as Sam Kerr and Pernilla Harder said in their interviews. A sign of a truly top, top, ruthless team that Emma Hayes has built over the years.
Manchester United in their first ever FA Cup final. Mark Skinner said even before the match kicked off that lessons would be learned. It's going to be a steep learning curve no matter what happened today. First big occasion this team have taken part in. They gave Chelsea a good game, but it is Emma Hayes, the serial winner, and her team
now the Royal Box get themselves to over the line. Winners medals and the Women's FA Cup. Let's hear it for Chelsea!
They'll be picking up the winners' medals from His Royal Highness, the Prince of Wales. And also handing out the medals today, Debbie Hewitt, MBE, FA Chair, and Sue Hoff, MBE, Chair of the Women's Football Board. Kirsty Lees, Chief Risk Officer at Vitality, sponsor of this cup. Sam Kerr receiving her medal there from Prince William. They were together last week at the coronation.
Besties.
And the winner's trophy, Corporal Lewis Jacobs from the military, will be handing over that piece of silverware. Represents her cap badge and the army in football, playing up to combined service level and in international fixtures as well. And Magdalena Eriksson, the captain, will become the first woman to captain her club to 3 consecutive FA Cups. Her 4th in total. Took over the captaincy in 2018 after the retirement of Karen Carney. And good to see Millie Bright, vice-captain as well, up there despite being out for a couple of months now with a knee injury. Millie Bright has been there since the start of this trophy-winning campaign for Emma Hayes. Now 12 in the cabinet for Chelsea. The 53rd edition, 438 teams entered, and Chelsea have once again come out on top. It's Chelsea.
Silverware for Chelsea. So many of these players have been ever present in this squad for the last few years and have lifted that trophy before. It's not a new experience, but it's still a joyous one, Farah. Doesn't matter how many times. We should speak to Alex, actually, about multiple winners.
Oh, I don't like Gabby.
We're going to go there. Let's go to Alex. It never gets boring, Alex.
It never does, because once you're used to having a trophy, you want that feeling time and time again. And actually, that's your motivation, because I think Erin Cuthbert said, coming into this game, this Chelsea team know they have a target on their back. Everyone wants to be the team to beat them, and they have to keep going and keep going, which they do every season.
Even the neutral fans, Gabby Logan, want Man United to beat Chelsea today. So they have that extra pressure of everybody outside of Chelsea wanting them to lose every season, because they want to see something new. They want the game to change, and they want a new name on trophies. But this Chelsea team know how to win.
But you made the point as well, though, that actually that pushes the other teams on. They have to get better. They have to push their standards to reach the standards that Emma Hayes has set.
It does, and I think they have. I think you look at how competitive the title race is this season. Each team is pushing on higher and higher.
OK, let's hear then from the defeated manager, Mark Skinner. He is with Joe Curry.
Well, Mark, in the end, it came down to the tightest of margins. Where did that game get away from you?
In a moment, we switch off in one moment. They throw a ball in to right, and it drifts off the outside, plays the ball through, space for Sam to run. We've kept it quiet all game. That's what you can do. They don't give us space and they don't hardly do anything. But I think the reality is I'm really proud of what the girls have done today. But as you've seen there, we're hungry. So they might be winning it now, but that's not where they're going to be in the future. That's what we want to take. So we're a team that will come again. We're a team that's hungry, young, energetic, and now just going to find the right little pieces to make sure we are challenging all the time.
Having dominated for such large periods of that time, and then the goal came, did that just simply knock the wind out of your sails?
Not really. I think they're their best when they don't have the ball. They're not a possession-based team. And so for me, it's about what they do with their moments, which is they're quick on transition. They train that clearly. And so that's just because they move quickly. And so we could have done better on that, but I can't knock anything. The girls are exceptional. They kept Sam super quiet. Chelsea have done hardly anything in the game. But it's a reality. They're winners for a reason. That's what we'll find, that tiny little gap, and then I don't think we'll look back.
This one will hurt. It's written all over your players' faces right now, but you can't afford to grieve this for too long, can you? Because you've got a league title to go and fight for as well.
Oh, absolutely. Well, we won't. We'll have to say, I want to thank all of the fans because they were magnificent, but we don't dwell on things. We use it, it fuels us. So that's why I said, like, if you watch us all lining up, we're watching it, because that will be us in the future. I have no doubt about that.
Thank you so much for speaking to us, Mark.
Thank you.
Mark Skinner said there, it's the little pieces that Manchester United have got to find so that they can beat the likes of Chelsea in an FA Cup final. What are those pieces? What was it today, Siobhan, that you think that Manchester United were lacking?
I think experience is one of them. And today is exactly where they gained those pieces. They gained that experience. And that will help them next year to go on and go that one step further. But something we've spoken about time and time again today is clinicalness, ruthlessness. And ultimately, that's what cost them.
Well, we have winning manager Emma Hayes with us in the studio. Congratulations, Emma. I mean, an unbelievable record that you're setting in terms of the repeat offenders coming here and winning time and time again. This is like home, right?
You know, we've played here more times than we have Stamford Bridge. So, yes, it's a home, but it was a slog. And you can't underestimate the game's accumulation. I thought we looked absolutely knackered today, especially the first half. In fact, I felt tired. So we all had to, like, kick each other a little bit at half-time.
How important are those mental preparations that you give your team when they are tired and they have this amount of games on the bounce?
You know what? We know how to stay in a game, and even if we weren't at our best, I could see couldn't time our press right, couldn't possess the ball properly. Then it's about executing the right info at half-time, which they took on board. Then it's the timing of the finishers.
But that's a pattern in the WSL this season, isn't it? There have been times where you've been down, you haven't, but somehow you come back. And a team like Manchester United, that first half, especially that first offside goal within a minute, they set their intentions, didn't they? They knew they had to come at you.
Yeah, I mean, it's a coach's nightmare. We don't do the kick-off properly. We don't do the second phase. We don't do the third phase, the fourth phase, the fifth phase. They deserve a goal for us being sloppy. So I knew then we need to wake up, and it took us 45 minutes to do that.
Do you know what? 12 major... Sorry, Alex.
I said, that's why I'm laughing, and that's why she's a winner. You can hear the... Even though, just lifted the cup, she's like, we did this wrong, she did that wrong.
Well, I was about to list 12 major honours, 5 WSLs, 5 FA Cups. I mean, and potentially another one coming in the next week, if you can pick them all up from whatever happens tonight.
I've got to get them home tonight. That's what I have to do. They know the bus is leaving at 9 o'clock, and it will leave, and everyone will be on it for sure. But they deserve credit, the players, for just being able to dig it out. And Man United are showing what a wonderful team they're developing.
How special is Sam Kerr?
Priceless. But let's credit Pernille Harder. Been out a long time. We knew we had to have more stretching runs. I nearly made the sub at half-time, but I held off to try and see which ones I thought were going to struggle in the first part of the second half. They reacted as well as they could, and we made the right decisions with our bench today.
I'm worried Emma's going to miss the trophy celebration.
They better
to run over.
They better wait.
She's been to a few before.
Yeah,
just one more question, which is how you keep these players happy. You've got world stars in your team.
I don't.
How?
I do not. If you think I do, you're delusional. Let me tell you, I have miserable faces all week if they're not starting.
You better run.
They're calling me.
They play for you. You want to see your sprint finish.
See you later.
Thank you so much, Emma. Congratulations. We can't let keep her away from that, can we? Even though she's had a few of those. You never get bored of them, as we say. She's made it. She's coming. And they're waiting for their boss, who she says she can't keep happy, those stars there. But she does something. She's managed to manage them to so much success. And as a manager, well, her record is incredible. It is the most prolific in the women's game.
Unbelievable scene there, Alex. These are the moments that make you really, really miss football.
What, the winning, Farah?
Yeah, I didn't do that much.
You've done a special
I pretty much first. Spent most of my time here applauding the winners.
I think what's so important here
right now.
So important here is being able to see how united they are as a group. It's not just the players. They didn't lift the trophy without their manager, and they're inviting every single member of staff in there. It's a united group of staff and players all together, and that's what you need to be successful.
Yeah, I mean, obviously she was, I think there was a bit of tongue-in-cheek when she says she doesn't, manage to keep them all happy, because there are miserable faces when she tells big stars they're not starting for their Chelsea side, who they think they should be. But she has managed to keep these big global stars in this squad, and she just, every year, tinkers with it a little bit, Farah. She brings in another talent, somebody else that, might add something special to this squad.
She already, at the beginning of the season, had her signings made for the end of this season. So Emma Hayes is always thinking a season ahead. I spoke to her before the start of the season, excited by the players she brought in this year. and she told me that she's already got players for next year. So she's forever evolving this Chelsea team and adding quality to it so that they stay at the very top. And I mentioned that before. It's now for the teams around them to try and catch them.
Well, there's a couple, a few definitely will be leaving at the end of the season. Pernille Harder is one of those who's been mooted to be moving on. And she will be, from her impact today, you'll see what a miss she will be. Let's have a little look at her, Farah, because she came off the bench and changed the game.
For sure, and I think Emma Hayes mentioned it there. It, the fact that she was able to stretch the play, the amount of ground she made up to get herself in the 18-yard box here, to get a shot away and support Sam Kerr, is phenomenal. The run but beyond here, the back line, it's difficult to defend. Slightly offside on this occasion. But it's the goal, it's the run for the goal that is the most important. You'll see it here, it's the run beyond the back line and in a position on the pass for Sam Kerr to just tuck it away. Sorry, this is another chance that she gave them. This is the chance for the goal. The pass here, the quality on that, Alex, is just phenomenal. We were up in the gantry up there, like, literally off of our chairs.
You know, us were a bit more excited than others.
Of course, being a fan of Chelsea.
Well, the thing is, when you get into this area, this is the difference between a world-class player. Being able to look up and execute the right pass with the pace. Sam Kerr said, when I was speaking to her this week, her visualisation, she was already visualising her scoring at Wembley and doing that celebration.
It's the perfection on the ball across. It gives Mary Earps no chance. As a goalkeeper, you want to be able to come out and clear that. You want to be able to come out and help your defenders. But the pass was so perfect. She had no opportunity to do that. And it was brilliant.
Well, United certainly gave us all, every neutral anyway, a good finish there, didn't they? And they threw everything at it there at the end.
They really did. And they will go away devastated. But like you said, it's learning the lessons and going again. And actually, one of the big things that we were just talking about, Gabby, when you're mentioning players like Harder, is for Manchester United to next season keep on to their superstars and to build and to not lose them.
I think keeping hold of Russo in January was huge for Man United in terms of keeping them in the title run and allowing them to get to the FA Cup final. So you're right, Alex, if they want to improve and be here again next year, they need to add on that.
Russo is the one that gets most of the headlines and she's the one that everyone talks about. They need to get her to sign the contract. For me, Ono Badje is just as important. She's phenomenal for them. Every time down that right-hand side, assist after assist this season, and she causes so many problems. She needs to be signing a contract for Manchester United.
But when he talked about the pieces, where do you think he's going to recruit then, Mark Skinner? Where do you think he sees the gaps?
I think it depends on which players he manages to keep and sign new contracts. If he loses the likes of Russo, he needs a goal scorer. But I think he needs to add more depth in his side of world-class winners, players that have got the experience of winning trophies for their countries, for their teams domestically. He needs that winning success to give them the experience.
You know what, I think the difference between the two teams, honestly, I said it before, when you look at who Emma Hayes is bringing off the bench and making a difference, I think it was a huge mistake to bring off Nikita Paris. She was the one making runs, getting at defenders. Once you took her off, the dynamic changed within the United front line. And I think that's the pieces next season he's going to have to look at.
I think Alex is right there. I think the energy Nikita had in that opening 55 minutes for sure was Man United's most effective player down that right-hand side. He actually took her off and put Ella Toon out on the right-hand side, an unnatural position for Ella Toon to play. So you took a lot of Man United qualities away when you took Nikita out of the team. So Emma Hayes said here her subs made a difference. From United, maybe that's what took the game away from them.
Yeah, it's those fine margins, isn't it? And those moments in games which change things. And Nikita Paris has shown so much energy and commitment to what was a brilliantly high-pressing, attacking Manchester United side in the first half. They have the chances, but it's Emma Hayes who came out smiling once more. And from Chelsea, one of Emma Hayes' superstars, Scotland's Erin Cuthbert, is just wandering into studio. She's wandering gingerly, I'd say, into studio. She has got some strapping on, and she's just won an FA Cup, so we'll give her that. We've only got a few minutes left. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. What a day.
What a day.
Honestly, delighted. Tough game, actually. Man United were really good, made it really difficult for us.
You have your own.
and they were very good today. I think they had a really fast start. But, you know, we sorted things out at half-time and I think we got control of the game a bit more in the second half.
Yeah, it never gets boring for you, though, does it? We're saying you may be serial winners, you may be halfway towards another double, but, you know, teams are making it tougher for you. They want to break that stranglehold.
That's what I want. Like, I want to play in the biggest games. I want the games that are really really tight and you can really test yourself against the best. So it's exactly what we want because, you know, we want everyone to make each other better.
And tell us what it was like to play in a sold-out Wembley today.
Well, I was watching the England Euros, the final, and I thought, oh, never will I be able to play at a sold-out Wembley. But, you know, what a special occasion. It's so amazing how, you know, how far women's football's come in such a short time.
Such a short time and such a difference, but still the success keeps on going. So apparently you've got an early night. Don't know if Emma Hayes has told you.
No, we do have an early night. We've been well warned by the gaffer.
Where's your family? You said all your family come down on these occasions.
Yeah, I had my family down, so, you know, I make sure that I look at them and I find them before the game because I like to be, they settle me a little bit. You know, it can be quite overwhelming when you see so many people. So having that little bit of home from home is really nice.
You've got another piece in the jigsaw puzzle, though, to go. It's the WSL now.
Yeah, of course, it's a piece of the jigsaw. We're not going to get too carried away. I want more. Like, this isn't enough for a club like Chelsea. We want to be pushing on all fronts. We want to go for the league now. It's in our hands. We've got to control the controllables. We've got another game in 3 days, but that's been the norm for us quite a lot of the season. So I'm really enjoying it. Like, you ask any player, nobody wants to train. Everybody just wants to play games.
Erin, I'm going to be a killjoy. You've just won an FA Cup final, but as you mentioned, you've got a midweek game against West Ham and then Arsenal at the weekend. How much would this occasion have zapped something out of you today and the team?
Undoubtedly. Quite a lot, actually, but I think that's when we need to, you know, really drop on our squad. We've got a big squad for a reason. Everyone's kind of coming back in key moments and we're getting everyone back at a good time of the season. So we're going to really have to use and utilise the whole squad over the next week because it's going to be tough. It's going to take a lot out of our legs. And I think you can see after 90 minutes we were starting to tire a little bit. So I'm glad it didn't go to extra time this time.
Is this the best one ever for you?
Is this
the best one ever?
I think it's the hardest one. I think, honestly, like it was neck and neck for so long. I wouldn't say it's the best one ever because they're all honestly amazing. See, when I see my family there, it's nothing beats it.
Well, listen, have a big hug with them and try and enjoy a bit of the night and wish you all the best for the rest of WSL.
I'm going to be on soda water and lime tonight. See ya.
It's good for you. Yeah. See you later, Erin. Thank you so much, Erin Cuthbert, really encapsulating what it means. Well, today was a day of first, wasn't it? A first sold-out Wembley Stadium, the first time that Manchester United have made an FA Cup final, first VAR as well. But same old Chelsea, the Blues giving the Blues to Manchester United with yet another victory. From all of us, goodbye.
As we take our seats, our place in this iconic theatre, holding our breath, the first-timers versus the serial winners.
Turner! Berger makes the save!
All it takes is one moment. And a new chapter in history is written. Wembley is blue. Blue is the colour.
Deal with the cross. Agonising.
Chelsea are champions once more.